And the Flames getting ready for the Battle of Alberta. Final installment. We'll have that and send it to the Saddle Dome on Hockey Night in Canada after this.
Why settle for an ordinary yard tractor when you could have a Husqvarna? Outstanding versatility makes them the ideal working companion all year round.
Have a great experience.
Raise your expectations. Visit your dealer today.
From a past paved in victory comes a future filled with glory. Can-Am, the name is back, but the passion never left. I Can-Am, can you?
Why settle for an ordinary yard tractor when you could have a Husqvarna? Outstanding versatility makes them the ideal working companion all year round. Raise your expectations. Visit your dealer today.
Have a great experience.
We've taken everything we've learned from our 12th Dakar Rally win and put it into the athletic new 2007 Mitsubishi Outlander.
Expedia.ca presents Lesson 1, Conversing in Italy.
Ciao! Perché sei così bella? Cosa ti ha portato a Roma? Il vento? Le stelle?
The stars? No, the great European vacation sale? Yeah, right now, your perfect European vacation is on sale. Just choose your flight and the hotel of your dreams and presto, we'll get you there.
Aspetta, vengo con te.
Expedia.ca, your trip, your way.
This lush expanse of green does more than beautify our world. Trees help clean the air of carbon dioxide, a major greenhouse gas. As North America's largest recycler, last year alone, Waste Management recycled enough paper to save over 41 million trees. From everyday collection to environmental protection, think green, think Waste Management.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Tim Hortons Triple Chocolate Baked Goods. The Triple Chocolate Danish Cookie Muffin and the new Triple Chocolate Donut are all irresistibly chocolatey.
BC brings you a special weekend honoring the legacy of the Battle of Vimy Ridge. Live from Ottawa and France, coverage of the ceremonies and unveiling of the restored monument. An epic two-part reenactment of the Great War by the descendants of those who fought it. Celebrating and remembering the sacrifices and achievements of our veterans. Return to Vimy Weekend starts Friday at 10 with Peter Mansbridge and the National from France on CBC.
Calgary Flames are set to take the ice at the Pengrowth Saddle Dome. It's simple. If they win here tonight, they're in the playoffs. While for the Oilers, it's a rather merciful end to the regular season. Kelly, anything can happen in games like this, but what do you make of the mantra we've heard a lot of around here today, which is if the Flames can't find a way to beat the struggling Oilers to get into the playoffs, they don't deserve to be there.
Well, that's obviously true, Scott, but the thing is, I don't know if the Flames have actually handled the pressure all that well this past week. So what they have to do in this first period is quickly as possible take away the will and the spirit of that young Oilers team and make sure that there are no opportunities for the Oilers to get back in the game.
Yeah, there is another way for the Flames to get into the playoffs tonight. That's to have Nashville beat the Avalanche in Colorado. Last we heard, they were tied at one heading for the second period. So there'll be some scoreboard watching here tonight.
Yeah.
Kelly, a quick comment on the Oilers. They've won one in 19, but they're not going to roll over. They're starting Dwayne Rolison tonight. How worried should the Flames be? He could stand on his head.
He's a fantastic goaltender. Keep in mind, the Oilers rested him both games in Minnesota, so he's fresh for tonight's game.
All right, in the broadcast booth tonight, it's Mark Lee with Greg Millen. Mark.
Thank you, Scott. Many of the Flames are treating this one like a playoff game six. The psychology being if they lose, they still have tomorrow, game seven in Colorado. You'd think, though, there'd be a sense of desperation, Greg, to avoid the showdown. And the guy leading them with confidence right now is Jerome Iginla.
Well, your best players have to be your best players in key games, and Iginla certainly has been leading the charge for the Calgary Flames. He has 5 goals in his last 4 games. He has 9 points, and he seems to be getting that shot back that we've seen all season long, really, where he can beat goaltenders from anywhere on the ice.
5 years ago in this very game, game 81 of the 2002 season, the Flames, minus 8 regulars, went into Edmonton and spoiled the Oilers' playoff hopes. Can Edmonton turn the table today?
Well, Edmonton's had a horrible stretch. We all know that. They haven't scored in 8 periods. They got to find a way to score some goals. But as Kelly just mentioned, Wayne Roloson, for me, is the wild card here. He's been rested for a couple of games. He's ready to play. I talked to him this morning. He'd like nothing more than to upset the Calgary Flames and put them in a position where they might be out of the playoffs. And as you can see, he has that look in his eye, doesn't he?
He sure did this morning, too. The question tonight, will the Flames play with desperation and clinch a playoff spot, or will they play safe in the knowledge they still have tomorrow? Oilers and Flames next.
This portion of Hockey Night in Canada on CBC is brought to you by Ford, built for life in Canada.
Inspiration. Where does it come from? Is it conviction? The things you can't compromise on? Is it anticipation? Knowing where to be? Wherever it is, find your inspiration and you'll find greatness.
Murder now, Ranger.
Murder.
Murder.
Ranger Heptich is in over his head.
We'll send our best men.
No!
In Mary Walsh's new comedy, Young Triffy. To celebrate the nationwide release on April 6th, CBC Television would like to send you and a friend on a trip out east to attend a taping of This Hour Has 22 Minutes, plus $500 spending cash. For your chance to win, simply name a CBC series that Mary Walsh has starred in. It's that easy. Enter today at cbc.ca/contests. It'll be one heck of a trip.
Time to think about
how to invest my race.
You again. Do your dreams match your financial reality?
They will soon.
Hi, Joanne, it's Karen. I just got a nice promotion. Let's talk about accelerating my plan.
The Plan by Investors Group, a personalized approach to financial planning designed to help you prosper now and over time.
Since the Battle of Vimy Ridge, it slipped by, but the legacy of the Canadians...
Back at the Pengrove Saddle Dome, Flames, who've been trying to shake the Colorado Avalanche for about a month now, can tonight with a win over the Oilers or an Avalanche loss to Nashville. And as you can see, Colorado has scored in the second period, and the Avalanche lead the Predators 2-1. Flames will be quick out of the Saddle Dome tonight to fly to Denver for tomorrow night's game. You may recall it is the makeup of a game postponed in Denver because of a blizzard in late December, and who knew there might be so much riding on it. It'll be a winner-take-all scenario should Colorado beat Nashville tonight and the Oilers find a way against the Flames, all of which is to say the Flames would be best advised to take care of business here tonight and render tomorrow's game in Denver meaningless.
Joan Lapidus, as you remember the Battle of Vimy Ridge. Please remain standing, remove your hats, and join Canadian country music artist Tracy James in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard
Last time this season, it's the Battle of Alberta. For Calgary tonight, the stakes, playoff spoils. For Edmonton, a chance to be the spoiler. In goal for the Oilers tonight is Dwayne Roloson getting the start. He is rested, has not played the past two games against Minnesota. His eighth start versus Calgary this season, a record of 2-5. At the other end of the ice for Calgary, Mika Kiprusoff. In his eighth start of the season against Edmonton, he has allowed only 11 goals in seven games against Edmonton this year. The officials tonight, the referees, number 34, Brad Meyer, and number 35, Dean Warren. On the lines, Lyle Seitz and Ryan Galloway. Here we go. One more win. That's all the Flames need to clinch the final playoff spot in the Western Conference and avoid that showdown tomorrow in Colorado. That or hope the Avalanche lose tonight against Nashville. In a full house here at the Pengrowth Saddledome for this important final home game of the season for Calgary. And Roloson batting that one to the neutral zone. Here's Byron Riching getting back in the lineup tonight for the Flames. His pass through the crease and nobody there to capitalize for Calgary. It's dumped in by Torres. Mark Giordano also in the lineup tonight for Calgary. As Jim Playfair makes two changes, adding Giordano and Byron Richie and scratching Jeff Friesen and Andre Zuzan. At the line, a quick snapshot goes over top of the net and careens back to center ice. David Hale playing in place of the injured Robin Regier, and they get it back in. Here's Alex Tanguy now, a shot, rebound right in the crease, and Aginla stared at it but couldn't pull the trigger. At the point, David Hale again, a wrist shot off a skate, a rebound for Tanguy, and he hits Tom Gilbert. Back up ice, Hemsky now, his pass off the skate of Passan. He still has control, turning at the half boards, and his pass comes out over the line and back inside the Edmonton zone. Passan now regrouping inside his own line. The captain, Jason Smith, bouncing it. But Ladislav Schmid turning at his corner, avoiding Lankow on the forecheck. Two Flames in deep. Eustalius can't keep it in. And the Oilers have it broken up on a back check by Lankow at center ice. Hammerlin back to Phaneuf with steam through the neutral zone. His pass off the stick of Toby Peterson. And the Oilers throw it back down the ice. Tipped by Eustalius just to the line. Calgary trying to get it. Change as Jason Smith feeds it to center ice. Toby Peterson gains the line, feeding it back in front. Thorsson shot, rebound to Peterson, and a save by Kiprusoff. As this third line got something going for the Oilers. Thorsson now turning in front of Phaneuf at the half boards. His pass intercepted by Eustalius, and he dumps it down ice. Tom Gilbert, it is 12th game for Edmonton. Up the right side to Matt Green. Green dumping it. Lupul on the chase. Giordano plays it back along the boards in the corner. Amati now tries to cycle back and will pick it up in the corner. Ahead to Wayne Primo to center ice. Up the right side, a dump in, a long shot, and Roloson will hang on for a whistle.
And then a little pushing and shoving afterwards here as Primo is into the act. Both teams in this first period early here get some good chances. And Kiprusoff had to be very sharp moments ago as Toby Peterson was wide open in front of the net after a rebound was let off and a little bit of a handcuff there by Kiprusoff, and he was able to recover beautifully. The Calgary Flames did exactly what they wanted to do in the first period, and that's get right after the Edmonton Oilers to try and get an early chance or two. And they certainly did that. Roloson did get a break on that first chance as the puck rolled through his crease and nobody could catch up to it.
Well, you're right. Roloson had that look on his face this morning after practice, like he could be a thief here tonight and steal one for Edmonton. Dumped in behind the goal now. Flames cycling, pass in front for Tanguy. It's off a stick and out. Marc-Antoine Pouliot gets it inside the Calgary zone. Reasoner now playing it along the boards. Pouliot knocked down, gets the puck to Torres. He tries to come in front, loses it in his skates.
And it's played off the glass and down the ice. Matt Green, a pass to center ice Pouliot, leaving it for Torres. Torres across the line ahead for Reasoner. Reasoner on the backhand, can't get the shot through. Stewart takes him off the puck. Aginla now picks up the loose puck at the half boards. Ahead to Byron Richie. Richie dumping and chasing. Savretnow along the glass to Pisani. Pisani battling in the boards in the corner now. Gives it up to Yell. Off a stick in behind the goal. Pisani now playing it around the boards to the near side. Hemsky dumping it high and down the ice. Horkoff back in after missing the last game. Leaves it for Pisani. Back to the point for Hemsky. Hemsky now in the corner. Knocked off the puck. A quick shot by Horkoff. And Kiprusoff with a glove save for Calgary.
Well, it's been a busy night in the National Hockey League, a very exciting one. Here are the playoff matches we know so far in the Eastern Conference. It will either be the Islanders or Toronto against Buffalo. The Islanders need a win tomorrow. By the way, that game will be on TSN. Pittsburgh, Ottawa. Ottawa getting the home ice advantage. And, of course, out west, Calgary needs a win tonight to set up against Detroit. And we'll get to more of that in a moment.
Coming right down to the last game of the season. Lanco dumping it right around the boards. Peterson shovels it quickly up to Jack Stortini. He had trouble with the puck, and now Lombardi gives chase on the forecheck for Calgary. He bounces off Jason Smith, and the Oilers will send it right down the ice. Kiprusoff will leave it for Giordano. Setting up behind his own goal. Lankow dropping for Giordano. Right back to Lankow, who's been red hot the last four games with 7 points. Huselius now turning in the high slot. Still has it. Has a chance for a shot. Holds it. Now plays it in the crease. Rebound, and it's chipped just aside as Rolison got a piece of it. Lost the stick. Jump back in the Calgary zone. Oilers changing en masse. There's a dangerous cut in front by David Hill, but he gets the pass wired to center ice. There's a shot by Aginla that just misses and comes all the way back down inside the Calgary zone.
That's a setup shot. Aginla will go low next shot after just about taking Rolison's head off on that one.
Aginla with 5 goals and 4 assists the last 4 games. A pass in front for Tange, and a penalty coming here to the Oilers. Here's a chance and a delayed call, and finally the Oilers will touch it. And more pushing and shoving involving Winchester, but it's a hook.
Right in the slot. And Reasoner is going to go to the penalty box for that little hook when the puck was settled in, going into the slot for a scoring chance for Calgary. Let's have a quick look at it. And Reasoner right here. There's that little hook to eliminate the scoring chance, and the Calgary Flames get the first power play of the hockey game.
The Flames power play has struggled against Edmonton this year, scoring just 3 times in 40 power play chances. That's 7.5% against the 10th ranked penalty kill unit in the NHL. Back up ice. A missed chance there for Huselius, and it's sent right back in by Matt Green. Hammerlick now turning and leading the rush for Calgary. Across the line, headmans the puck into the skates of Lankow, and he's checked by Thorsson. They get it across the line. Hammerlick does. Hammerlick playing it back to Huselius. Huselius turning at the point now as they switch positions. Coming in down low. Aginla tries to back in front, and it's cleared back to the point, but not out. Hammerlick now ahead to Huselius. Huselius in the slot, a one-timer. Lankow, rebound off the skate of Green, and Thorsson will take it back up ice for Edmonton. Green joining the rush, pass to Green, it bounces off his stick, and he's hammered in the end board. Thorsson on the loose puck, though, for the Oilers. Playing it deep down the ice to the neutral zone, and Green comes all the way back to gobble it and make the play. Hammerlin turning with 50 seconds to go in the Calgary power play. Head to Lombardi with speed, gets around Schmid. Lombardi plays it round behind the goal, it comes back to the point now. Panouf, D to D, Hammerlick now. Ahead to the corner. Tangi at the half force to the point. Panouf winds and fires, misses, rebound. And Lombardi didn't have a good enough angle. Holding on and turning at the boards now. Playing it down low to Tangi. Tangi in front. Lombardi couldn't get the shot away. Oilers can't get it out. Now they do. As Horkoff gets it to center ice. Tanguy turning. More pressure now. Lombardi in the dying seconds of this power play. 15 to go. Turning at the half boards. Down into the corner for Tanguy. Tanguy in front. One-timer by Stewart. And Moss bangs away at it. But Rollison closes the door again.
Well, Rollison looks very sharp in this first period of play. On this power play by Calgary, he has made a couple of big-time saves. And the last one was one of those. A little give and go down low by the Flames. Stewart goes to the net in perfect positioning by Dwayne Rollison there to make the save. And here is the other save as well earlier on the power play. And Rollison's moving very well laterally so far in this hockey game.
Hale wins the draw back to Hale. He winds up a shot right on a fat rebound. Richie can't get there first. The penalty to Reasoner is over. Edmonton back to full strength. Four shots on that power play by Calgary, but Rollison was equal to the task. Nielsen playing it back inside the corner. Hale quickly ahead to Brad Stewart. The one-timer off the stick of Richie. He's got it, though, off Torres. Here's a chance now. Richie, Yell steaming into the slot, and the rebound is smothered by Dwayne Rollison. CBC's Hockey Night in Canada returns in a moment.
Bud Light presents Blatant Marketing Ploys.
During the playoffs, companies like to entice you with free hockey stuff.
Not official.
Weird. So sad. Blatant ploy? Totally. But if you're giving away free stuff, make it worth keeping.
That's why Bud Light, proud sponsor of the NHL, is giving away one of 18 official NHL Stanley Cup champions hats, and specially marked cases of Bud Light.
Great hat, great beer.
You can't lose. Must be legal drinking age, no purchase required.
If you're over 50 with a good driving record, you could save up to $400 per year on your car insurance through Grey Power. Because at Grey Power, we believe that if you're over 50 and have a good driving record, you've earned the right to save. So call or visit us online right now for a free, no-obligation quote. Call now and get the power of 50+.
Call 1-866-494-5013 or go to graypower.com.
Yes, it is the best that I can do.
You gotta be kidding me.
Hey, come on, it's 9:30, you gotta hang up.
No, if I do, the deal won't close.
It'll go through tomorrow. Come on, you gotta get you home. I need the bonus. But I'm gonna have to call you in the morning.
High blood pressure can triple your risk of stroke. So who better to help you than you when it comes to preventing one? Learn more at heartandstroke.ca/bloodpressure.
Congratulations to the entire Vancouver Canuck organization that won their division today. They will play the Dallas Stars. By the way, Bieksa, he went for precautionary x-rays. He should be okay and ready to go for game one. We look at the rest of the matchups. Tampa Bay, Jersey, Rangers, Atlanta, Minnesota, Anaheim, San Jose, and Nashville. I am looking forward to this year's playoffs because nobody really knows who's going to get out of the first round, particularly in the Western Conference.
Boy, in that Vancouver-San Jose game, Matt Cook avoiding what looked like a serious injury opportunity there on the hit from Joe Thornton into the end boards. Good to see he's okay to go. Blanco tries to keep it in. Now it comes out to center ice. Giordano sending it right back inside the Edmonton zone. Winchester along the boards. Leads the rush up the right side through center ice. Joffrey Lupul, who has struggled this year, can't control the puck, has it knocked off his stick. Back come the Flames. Huselius with Lankow. Turning now. Huselius inside the Edmonton zone. Look at him move. Now he sets up Stewart. A shot right on. And Rollison holds on. No rebound with four Flames in the crease.
One of the complaints on Lupul's season is not so much his production. Obviously, the Oilers would like him to score more, but his defensive play as well. And this is a play in the neutral zone here. Trying to beat three guys when the Flames are lined up. Huselius is the last guy you want to have in the counterattack. The Flames counterattack back, and all because of the giveaway wave down in the other zone, it creates this good chance to score. And again, Rollison had to be sharp.
Shot at the point is blocked by Pisani. Stewart leaves it for Tanguy. Lupul with 28 goals last year in Anaheim, just 16 this season for Edmonton. Tanguy plays it around the boards for Stewart. Craig Conroy is back for Calgary, chipping it high and down the ice. Right on goal, icing waved off as it had to be played by Rolison. Pisani now. Long pass, too far for Hemsky. And David Hale will touch up, icing the call against the Oilers. The Oilers coming into this game, Greg, with 9 road losses in a row. Another one here tonight will set a new team record.
And at the other side, Jim Playfair asked his team this morning to come out with urgency, get on the body, and get on it early so that everybody is into the game. And he must be happy so far, other than the Flames not scoring with his team's first period.
Phaneuf now, wrist shot high, and a glove save by Rolison.
And the Calgary Flames, when they had Colorado breathing up down their necks, rather, really turned it up. And these last 8 games have been excellent for the Calgary Flames in all departments, particularly in the goals against.
Well, in those 6 straight wins, Kiprusoff had a 1.47 goals against average.
He's had a 1.59 goals against average in the season series against Edmonton this year so far.
Pretty stingy. Phaneuf again fires it on the net. It's blocked before it gets there. Stortini now, his pass too far for Thorason, and back off the boards. Gilbert now quickly on the puck. And here comes Toby Peterson. Peterson from a sharp angle. Fat rebound. Thorason on it. A bouncing puck high through the crease and cleared. At the point now, Savrette throws it at the net. It's blocked in front. Thorason now loses control. There's a penalty coming here to Calgary. Thorason tries to get it back in front. Primo on him. And finally, Hamrlik will touch it for a whistle. And interference will be the call against the Flames.
Good shift for the Edmonton Oilers as they take the puck towards the net, get some shots on goal, and now draw a penalty. And as you mentioned, Hamrlik's on his way to the penalty box for interference. And right in the slot when the puck was bouncing around, Hamrlik got a little bit too aggressive there, and that was the call on Peterson.
So Hamrlik off for interference at 9:32. Zach Stortini really drawing that, and he's been drawing some rave reviews from his coach, Craig McTavish, for his enthusiasm and his work ethic and his willingness to stick his nose into traffic. He's won himself a good look next year in training camp in this Oilers organization. Horkoff now backing into the corner, in behind the Flames' goal. Off the boards, and Hemsky did a pirouette, seemed to lose his balance, and Conroy will play it down the ice.
2-1 Colorado with 4 minutes left in period 2, just for a quick update on that game.
Flames continue to be the hunted here in the last week of the season. Horkoff dumping and chasing, playing banged up in the last few weeks of the season.
I think Rhett Warner went to bat the puck and missed it, and the puck hit him right in the face. And he seems to be okay.
A little slow to get up.
Let's have another quick look here if it was a stick or the puck. Nope, it's the puck, as he completely missed the puck when he was trying to bat it down and ended up with the puck right in his face. And as you can see, it was deflected by Marcus Nielsen as well, and I'm sure that handcuffed him.
And Warner has gone to the Flames locker room. It didn't look like the puck was traveling with much velocity, but
it can clip you and cut you pretty easily.
Yep. Hamsky now along the boards, turning, gets in the way of the official, and a bouncing puck gets out to center ice. Sikora to Green. Sikora, who has 4 goals to lead the Oilers in 7 previous games this year against the Flames, and is dumped in again by Pisani. Pisani giving chase on Hale along with Hemsky. And Hale kicks it ahead. The Oilers control it at the line. Sikora to Horkoff. Down low, Hemsky now. Hemsky plays it back to the point. Sikora fakes the shot. Gilbert back to Sikora. Sikora to Tom Gilbert. Now Gilbert right at the dot, plays to Pisani. A shot right on off the blocker, and a big rebound from Kiprusoff, which is cleared away. Gilbert knocked off the puck, and the Flames will get it out. He breaks his stick, Gilbert does, and heads right to the bench. Pisani now with 20 seconds to go in the Oiler power play. Marty Riesner dumping and chasing. Torres giving chase, and it's whistled it offside at the line.
Well, Kiprusoff has been sharp in this first period. He hasn't been all that busy, just 5 shots on him, but when he has been busy, he's been good, as he Oilers have had a couple of good chances to score the latest right in the slot here. Kiprusoff is so good laterally, and he's looking over top. See how he looks right over top of the traffic, and that allows him to make this save as Horkoff was right on the doorstep.
Jim Playfair was saying this morning that this year, when facing 27 shots or less, Calgary is 16-3-2. So far, just 5 Oiler shots. There's one right on from Schmid, and easily handled high by Kiprusoff.
And yes, Kiprusoff has been hot the last 8 games, as has his team. Look at the save percentage, 9.32. And he's in that zone. I talked to him last weekend about that, and he said, why wouldn't I be? It's playoff time.
He's an amazing work ethic, stretching at home before he comes to the rink, stretching in the room before games, stretching after everybody's left, paying close attention to detail in his preparation and warm down. Jason Smith now up the boards to Torres. The Flames back to full strength, and the Oilers put 2 shots on goal during that power play. Kiprusoff plays it around the boards, gets it past Torres to center ice, and Jason Smith will send it right back in. An odd bounce, and that nearly snuck in front. Fans trying to get the Flames going here. Tanguay's pass on the stick of Lankow across the line. He winds his shot off the stick of Green and missing the net. Lankow quickly back to Phaneuf at the point. He fans on it but keeps it in. Along the near boards, far boards rather, into the corner now. Gimlet tries to shoot from a sharp angle. Rather, Lombardi. Now Lombardi battling behind the goal with Green. Knocked off his feet by the big Oiler defenseman. Lankow loses the puck. Lombardi on it. A backhand pass that nearly fooled Rolison as it bounced up on the short side. You're watching Hockey Night in Canada in high definition on CBC.
Checks have arrived just in time for the legendary Midnight Madness sale at the Brick. Get your $300 Mad Money bonus check until Sunday only. Shop today and save an extra $300 on furniture and mattresses. The sale prices throughout the store. Plus, you don't pay for 15 months. The Brick's legendary Midnight Madness sale. Get your $300 Mad Money bonus check or shop online at thebrick.com. Hurry, it ends Sunday. Don't miss it.
To learn more about Rona by Design, visit rona.ca. It's your interactive tool for renovating in style. Rona.ca, from the Canadian how-to people.
With Rona by Design, choose from among the latest styles to realize the home facade of your dreams and earn Air Miles Reward Miles. Rona, the Canadian how-to people.
Dwayne Rolison almost gets caught in a pretty sharp play by Matthew Lombardi. Lombardi, boy, he turned into a great hockey player. Look at his puck control here as Green is all over him. Terrific balance, good edges. And then Lombardi will come. Now, just stop it here, guys. Watch him look. He's going to look right now and then put his head back down on the puck and then filter the puck right towards Dwayne Rolison, trying to find Lankow. And that almost worked. That was a nifty little play by Lombardi.
Lombardi trying to dig himself out of a slump with 1 goal in the last 17 games. Aginla tries to play it in front. Still loose in the high slot. Oilers on it. Rafi Torres now takes it to center ice and will gain the line. Turning at the blue line, his shot bouncing off of Hamrlik, who was high for the Flames. And the Oilers will dump it back in. Dion Phaneuf setting up behind his own goal. The Oilers drop off to the neutral zone. Marcus Nielsen playing to the line and a hand pass. The call against Calgary.
After 2 periods of play now over and done with, the Avalanche still up on the Nashville Predators 2-1.
Jim Playfair was talking about his team playing better as the hunters as opposed to the hunted, saying that the last two games when they've been behind, they played with more desperation. But they haven't played well when they've had a lead, and they certainly haven't been able to close out this playoff spot with Colorado hunting them. And
that stuff was too confusing for me. They just got to go out and win a game and control a game from start to finish like they have so far in this first period. Give Edmonton credit, though. They've come out ready to play, and Dwayne Rolison has been sharp in net.
So they're still the hunted. With the Avalanche one period away from winning tonight at home against Nashville, then waiting for a possible showdown against the Oilers. Should they lose here, or rather the Flames, should they lose here tonight? Salius chipping it high off the stick of Lombardi. He can't control it. Smith gets it out. Bouncing puck. Husalius now across the line. Christian Husalius feathers it ahead to Lombardi. A sharp shot off the mesh. In behind the goal now. Calgary with a chance here. Hits a stick, and Hemsky back up ice all by himself on a one-on-three situation. Now Thorsson off the bench as Hemsky has it checked off his stick by Phaneuf. Phaneuf turning and quickly up ice to Husalius. Husalius dumping and changing. Green battles for the puck in the corner. Along the boards, the Oilers will get it out again. Zach Stortini now bouncing it and chasing past Hammerlick. He's there first for Edmonton. In behind the goal, Phaneuf has it, plays it around, and ahead to the captain. Gimlin now across the line. Tanguy just kept his skate in the paint to avoid being called offside. Battling along the far boards now. Ginla with 9 points in the last four games, leading this Calgary team on his shoulders. A bouncing puck out over the line, over the stick of Phaneuf. Hammerlick. Tanguy, he plays it right back inside the zone as the Oilers were changing. Tanguy now across the line. Knocked in the board, still has it, plays it in front to a charging David Moss. And his one-timer is stopped by Rolison. No score here with 4:56 to go in the first.
Man, you guys got some really great deals today.
Yeah, it's our
holiday weekend
sale.
I almost can't decide what to buy first.
Yeah, that's what it's like at the
holiday weekend
sale.
But how do you guys afford such low prices with the
holiday weekend
sale?
Oh, we just shoot one commercial and then we run it again for every sale, like this one.
Holiday weekend
sale.
Save now on a huge selection of the latest technology.
Naturally irresistible cheese.
The Edmonton Oilers in this first period of play have done an excellent job staying low in the zone in front of the net and collapsing in front of the goaltender. The Calgary Flame points will be open, and they've got to start using them as Edmonton's collapsing right in front of Dwayne Rolison.
The Oilers have had trouble scoring goals in the last month. They've been shut out three times during this six-game losing streak and struck a defensive posture here with but six shots on goal in the first period. Marcus Nielsen with Richie. Reisner knocks him off the puck and kicks it ahead off the boards. Ahead to Lupo, kept in at the line by Giordano. Around the near boards again. Behind the net, Matt Green. With Richie on him, plays it for Savret. He won't get there first. Oilers having trouble getting out of their zone. Savret plays it behind the goal over the stick of Matt Green. And a big hit from Richie on the forecheck. Chikora now back to help out with Stewart pinching down low. Along the boards, Giordano has to back off the blue line with Lupo there, and Lupo will send it just inside the line. Sikora now charging on the loose puck. Sikora, low shot, blocked by Stewart, still loose. Kicked into the corner. Pisani battling in the corner. And Yell is tied up, it seems. So they're playing Twister in the corner. Now a hand pass ahead to Giordano. He loses his footing momentarily. Plays it around the glass, but not out. Jason Smith back around behind the goal. Too high for Sikora. And he is hit hard by Stewart.
Interference. Puck wasn't near him.
Delayed penalty coming here for the Flames. Back to the point. Schmid down low. And Stewart will grab the puck for the whistle and complain.
He's just giving it to Dean Warren at the moment, saying that that wasn't interference at all. And let's have a look here. Pretty late. The puck was well gone out of the area by then. Sikora goes down. Stewart in the penalty box.
Off for interference at 16:40. Oilers 0-for-1 on the power play tonight with two shots in their last chance. And Playfair getting an explanation.
I think Stewart thought that the puck was right there, and it was for a moment, but then it went well past Sikora afterwards.
Oilers with a 27th ranked power play in the NHL. And there's a reason why Schmidt can't make the DDD pass and has to go back inside his own zone.
Remember Calgary, 15 shorthanded goals. They do try. That's third best in the National Hockey League.
Schmidt dumping and chasing for Edmonton. It's swatted around the boards. They're pinned by Hemsky in behind the Calgary net. Lombardi now with some speed. Up ice all by himself now as the Flames change, turning in front of Green. Green knocks him right off the puck. Horkov lugging it back to center ice to the left side. Torres now dropping it for Hemsky. Hemsky plays it back to himself, now to the point. Gilbert feathering it right on goal, bouncing high in front of the net. And the Flames come up with it. Lankow with Primo. Lankow's shot off the leg of Schmid. And Pouliot is back quickly to pick up the loose puck for Edmonton. Reisner now dumping it in for the Oilers. Pouliot has it go over his stick. Here's Torres on the loose puck. Can't find it. Along the boards now. Back to the point. Tom Gilbert. D to D. Danny Servette fakes the shot. The youngster's on D here. On this Edmonton power play. Servette quickly to Gilbert. Gilbert back to Servette. Ahead to Reisner. Shot high. Cleared around the boards, but not out. Servette there to keep it in for Edmonton. Servette coming in deep now. A shot right on. Fat rebound. Torres in his skates. Can't get the shot on the rebound. And Primo will clear it.
Both goalies have been extremely sharp in period one.
Danny Servette now. The last rush on this power play with 5 seconds to go. Thorsson in deep with Stortini. Oilers with 3 shots so far. And the penalty to Stewart is over. Back to the point. Stewart breaks up the pass to Jason Smith. Loose puck to Thorsson. The shot. And an easy one there. Glove by Kiprusoff. More pushing and shoving as Stortini, who loves to gab, gets involved. A reminder, tomorrow night on CBC, don't miss part one of The Great War, a remarkable documentary that brings together 150 descendants of Canada's first World War soldiers to reenact their ancestors' battles and provides a deep sense of this defining event in Canada's past. CBC's comprehensive Vimy coverage continues with part one of The Great War tomorrow at 8 on CBC. Conroy wins the draw. Stewart on the puck. In close battle there along the boards. And the Oilers come up with it. Thorsson, one hand, tries to get it ahead to Peterson. It's broken up and sent down the ice in this final minute of the opening period. Icing the call against Calgary.
I want to show you what Kiprusoff does at times when there's traffic in front of him. He'll use the traffic to regain his balance. There he's down. Watch what he does. He's going to push right off it there. And then stay in perfect position with Horkov And then up he gets. He's complaining to the official as well that that was interference afterwards. He's very good, Kiprusoff, even when he's getting pushed and shoved, to keeping his eye on the puck and staying in position.
Ginla wins the drop. Stewart plays it off the boards and around. Kicked back by Tange, and Pouliot was there to break it up. Pouliot now feathers it ahead to Reisner. Reisner with a shot blocked in front. Tange can't get on the loose puck. Oilers with a little flourish here in the final minute of this first period. Along the boards, Pouliot drops it blindly and is picked up by Conroy. Back comes the captain, Iginla, across the line as it knocked off a stick by Schmid and played back to the neutral zone. Warner back, plays it in. And Schmid plays it right back to center ice. Giordano now throwing it at the goal, turned aside into the corner by Rollison. Yell has it knocked off his stick. Oilers play it up the boards. Pisani now with Hemsky. Hemsky to center ice. Final 5 seconds. He'll take a shot right on and steered aside by Kiprusoff. The horn sounds to end the opening period. Calgary out shooting Edmonton 12-10. But no goals to show for it. No score. Flames and Oilers after one here at the Penn Gross Saddle Dome in Calgary.
With a Hotchkiss rear suspension and a strong rigid frame, the all-new Super Duty makes sure you don't feel the road. But with an all-new 6.4-liter turbo diesel V8 engine that churns out 600 pound-feet of torque, rest assured, the road will feel you. The all-new 2008 Ford Super Duty. Built for tough.
90 years after Vimy Ridge, the Queen, the Prime Minister, and thousands of Canadian students dedicate a memorial to Canada's coming of age. That's Monday on CBC News, The National.
Back at the Saddle Dome with Matt Lombardi of the Flames. Matt, simple question. Are you playing with enough urgency to take care of business here tonight?
Yeah, I think the guys, you know, we're all excited in the room. We came out with a lot of energy and, you know, we're getting some chances. Game plan, we want to get pucks to net. We've done that, and we just got to stay out of the box here, be disciplined, and get our chances, and create some opportunities on our power play.
Jim Playfair was saying earlier today he thought the problem in the last two games, in which the Flames' sense of urgency obviously declined a bit, was that you guys lost sight of the big picture and that you were focusing more on the little things as opposed to just getting the 2 points. Is that fair?
Well, I mean, you say what you want now. I think we're in the situation where. This is the biggest game of the year for us. I mean, we're not worrying about how we approach things in the past. We're, today was all about tonight, and right now it's all about the win. So we're focused on that. We're not worrying about anything else.
Watching the scoreboard quickly?
No.
Right. Last word, Colorado was leading Nashville 2-1. All right, thanks, Matt.
Thanks.
It's Matt Lombardi, the Flames. Here's Kelly Rudy. What do you got coming up on Behind the Mask?
We're going to talk about the Oilers' young defenseman, Tom Gilbert. We're going to talk about a hockey tournament as at yesterday that's going on here in the city. And there's this fantastic book about the University of Saskatchewan and their hockey program.
You missed the
and
big
more.
Story. Raj Binder's joining us.
I wasn't going to spill the beans.
All right. Looking forward to having him on Behind the Mask. The Flames and the Oilers are scoreless through one here at the Saddle Dome on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car for my trip? It's expensive.
It's not expensive, Ma.
They pick us up. Sounds expensive.
Pickup's free, Ma.
Well, if it's not expensive, why didn't you rent me a bigger car?
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
This junior chicken's pretty tasty. It's got a nice kind of spice to it. I think it's paisley.
It's not paisley.
How do you know?
Because paisley is a pattern on shirts and other textiles.
Oh, right.
You were thinking parsley.
Yeah. Parsley, that's the one.
Yeah, it's not parsley.
The Junior Chicken. It's got people talking. Just $1.39 any day you want it. Part of our Value Picks menu.
The world might not be made for you,
But our big and tall section is. Moores has a wide selection of big and tall clothing, from suits and sport coats to sportswear and outerwear at prices that won't knock you out. Moores, well-made, well-priced, well-dressed.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car for my trip? Looks expensive.
It's not expensive, Ma.
They pick us up. Sounds expensive.
Pickup's free, Ma.
Well, if it's not expensive, why didn't you rent me a bigger car?
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
There's always been a natural way to fertilize your lawn and garden, but now there's a way that's a little easier. All-natural home gardener Natura lawn and garden care products. Safe, organic, and available only at Home Hardware. And for weeding and aerating without bending or stooping, choose the Mark's Choice Speedy Weeder.
Not all the
The Mask with Scott Oak and Kelly Rudy. Brought to you by Ford, built for life in Canada.
Yes, before we get started, we're both really looking forward to After Hours tonight because we're finally going to have a broadcast journalist on the program who can make sense of things. Raj Binder, the chief sports correspondent for the program this hour, has 22 minutes. We'll join Kelly and I. Raj really has a way, Kelly, don't
he
you
does.
Think, of...
Yeah, he's a very accomplished broadcaster.
But of distilling things.
Yeah.
Watch.
Yeah, hey, listen, I'm very excited because I get to talk about the playoffs tonight. Myself, Kelly Rudy, and Scott Oak, we're all heading to an after-hours club, apparently, and we're going to party. What? Not like a disco, after-hours party with girls. Oh, well, okay, I guess I'm just going to be discussing the playoffs in Kelly Rudy's apartment or something, coming up after the Edmonton-Calgary game. You sure not? Big party?
I don't think Roger's ever watched After Hours.
No, I don't think so, but that doesn't matter. I can't wait for his spin on the Stanley Cup playoff tournament.
He looks calm and relaxed, too. There's no sweat or anything on his face.
No, he's very cool under pressure.
Man,
all right, let's make the turn to what's going on at the Penguins Saddledome tonight. By the way, they're just starting the third in Colorado and Nashville trails. The Avalanche 2-1 still, so the heat's kind of mounting here on the Flames. What about the sense of urgency I asked Matt Lombardi about?
Well, you know what? First off, after that first period, I'm sure in the Flames dressing room there's no panic. They're not down. They didn't fall down 2-0, and there weren't any bad breaks or anything. But on the other hand, that's not exactly the first period I had in mind for the Flames. This is a game that in which they can come out and they could have destroyed Edmonton's confidence right off the bat. Now, granted, Rolison was not bad, or pretty good, actually. The Flames, I thought, really only had some really good chances on that early power play. After that, you know what? If I'm a Flames fan, I'm actually a little bit nervous because I wanted to come out of this one dominant, hitting everybody, making sure, again, those young defensemen on the Oilers, that this is going to be a really tough game. And frankly, I didn't see that. I didn't see a bad period from the Flames, but I didn't see an overwhelming effort.
What about the worst case scenario for the Flames tonight? Then somehow the Oilers find a way against them in Colorado. Protects its lead against Nashville. They have to go to Colorado tomorrow in a winner-take-all scenario. Would you like their chances?
I wouldn't like their chances, but I don't say that they're going to fold their tents either because they have too many good players. When you have a world-class goaltender like Kiprusoff, one of the top three in the game, and Ginless seems to always rise to the occasion in all the big games, and they still have such a good, talented team that I wouldn't say that they're going to go there and they're going to automatically lose, but obviously that's not the scenario they want to be in. Yeah.
Such a tough spot the Edmonton Oilers find themselves in. You got to think a large part of their mindset tonight is let's just get this season over with, but they have some things to look forward to next year. Would a player like Tom Gilbert be one of them?
Absolutely. If I'm an Oilers fan, I like this guy and I want to watch him develop. Now here's Tanguay, and he's attacking the Oilers zone with Aginla, and the two defensemen to watch are right here, Green and Gilbert right there. And just take a look at Gilbert in front of the net, Tanguay with the shot, the rebound. Here's Gilbert again. He's going to slide back here with Jerome right off to the side of the net, and take a look at his strength. There's that rebound, and everybody knows that Jerome is one of the strongest players in National Hockey League. That is one incredible play. Now here's a shot again, and here's Gilbert in front again, just where he needs to be, reading the play. Here's the shot in front, and the deflection, and he sacrifices his body. That is some sort of understanding of the game for a young player. Again, that, on most players, is a sure goal. Now Gilbert's a big kid. He's 6'3", about 215 pounds. Other than that, I'll tell you what, not many young players can do that. He's 24 years old, Scott. I'll tell you what, if I'm an Oilers fan, I like this guy, and you know what, he's going to be a heck of a player, and he's offensive, too.
I want to take a moment to make mention of one of Calgary's long-standing minor hockey tournaments, the Crowchild Challenge. 32 teams from all over North America, and it opened last night.
And this was a real cool thing because it really brought me back to my days starting hockey when I was 12 years old. This is a Adam and Pee Wee tournament. Dion Phaneuf was there. In fact, Dion won the tournament, he thought, in 1999. Peter Marr, Paul Lawton, one of the organizers. And this is really a tournament about sportsmanship and learning about the game and respect and having fun. And so it was just really an excellent experience for me. I couldn't help but think when I was 12 starting out. And so if you have the interest and the time, tomorrow at 12:30 and 2:30 are the championship games at the Crowchild Arenas.
Tournament's 25 years old.
Isn't that something?
Yeah.
And it's getting bigger. They liken it to the Max tournament here, the midget tournament at Christmas time.
Teams from as far away as Los Angeles.
Yeah, right? I actually, some of the kids even knew me and stuff. It was kind of weird.
And they asked you about your blue bandana, right?
Yeah,
they did. Every hockey fan from
exactly.
LA does. We also want to mention a book that has been written by P.J. Kennedy, a professor of kinesiology at the University of Saskatchewan. He documents a lot of work in this, 97 years of history of the University of Saskatchewan hockey program. People like Billy Hay, Eddie Litzenberger, Max McNabb, Dick Irvin, Mike Babcock, Dave King, Shannon Miller have all gone through the program.
And Bill Remenda, you know who that is?
Yeah, Drew's father.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. He was the goalie coach for the team, I think, from 82 to 86. And this is really an interesting read. I'm having a great time going through this.
All the monies raised are going towards a men's hockey scholarship that P.J. Kennedy started 3 years ago.
That's right. And actually, that's his third hockey book that he's written. Ron McLean wrote the foreword for the first one. I wrote the foreword for the second. Now he's got a third book.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Well, it's been an awfully tough week for all of us at Hockey Night in Canada. We got some tragic news on Monday. Denny Faucan, one of our principal cameramen, died on Monday while hiking on the West Coast. Kelly, it's been hard not to think about him all day because Denny was supposed to be working on this very
Absolutely.
Telecast tonight.
I had the pleasure of working alongside Denny in Salt Lake City almost exclusively. He was my cameraman for that feature. We had Road to Gold. He was an avid outdoorsman, as you can imagine, by these pictures, and he's dearly missed by all of us. He's a wonderful cameraman and a wonderful person.
You know, he's responsible in many ways for Don Cherry's good looks, or at least maintaining them, because Denny was standing behind Don in the gold medal final at Salt Lake City, and a puck came flying towards Don, and Denny took it in the back of the head. So, he really loved the great outdoors, as you say. He moved to Canmore 2.5 years ago. He was a staple on our crew, and the thoughts of all of us on Hockey Night in Canada are with his parents, Claire and Raymond, his brother Darren and Elaine, and his sister Natalie. Denny Faucan was 45.
Behind the Mask.
Behind the Mask.
On Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Ford. Built for life in Canada.
There are two schools of thought on the new Super Duty. One says it's all about being big. Big engine, big payload. The other says it's all about the little things done right. Power scope mirrors, integrated tailgate step. One thing everyone agrees on, it's one tough truck. The all-new 2008 Ford Super Duty. Built Ford tough.
What did you see?
You see things before they happen.
I have no idea how, but I can.
There is a nuclear bomb somewhere in the United States. Find it.
Do exactly what I say. I'll save your life.
I don't want you to die.
Next.
It's happening.
When?
Now.
In theaters, April 27th.
Explore rich Swiss chocolate and discover honey and almond nougats. Hidden within. Lose yourself in the Toblerone Triangle.
This portion of Hockey Night in Canada on CBC is brought to you by Ford, built for life in Canada.
Yeah. at the Pengrove Saddledome, Flames and Oilers are through one, and they're scoreless, so nothing doing yet. In Denver, Colorado continues to lead Nashville 2-1. They're at the 6-minute mark now of the third period, so Colorado protecting its one-goal lead, and there's more than passing interest in this game on the part of the Flames and their fans. We'd like to remind you of our Bring Home the Cup contest, the ultimate hockey prize for a hockey fan available here. It's a Hockey Night in Canada shrine built in your home to your specifications, and around it you can host the ultimate playoff party for you and 20 friends. The cup will be brought home by six-time Stanley Cup champion Mark Messier. He'll deliver it to your home, and so you can go online to get the entry details. It's cbc.ca/bringhomethecup. It's the season's final edition of After Hours tonight. Kelly and I will be joined by Eric Tuhatchik, Greg Millen, to preview the Stanley Cup tournament, which starts on Wednesday. And we're not kidding anyone here. The real draw on tonight's program will obviously be Raj Binder, the popular sports correspondent for this hour is 22 minutes. He's going to join us via satellite or tape. What difference does it make? And you can send your questions to us. Here are the playoff matchups that we know right now. Toronto or the Islanders at Buffalo, Pittsburgh at Ottawa, Calgary or Colorado at Detroit, Dallas at Vancouver. So those are the ones involving Canadian teams. Tampa at Jersey, Rangers at Atlanta, Minnesota at Anaheim, and San Jose will open in Nashville. Second period next on the agenda here at the Pengrove Saddledome as the Flames continue to gun for a playoff berth on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Sometimes what seems like a good price on tires isn't really a great deal. Does the price include installation, valves, and balancing? At GM Goodwrench, your new tires include installation, valves, and balancing. Now that's a real offer on the brand names you know. For a limited time, get the right tires at the right price, starting from $89.95. For the real deal on great prices, visit your GM dealer or goodwrench.ca.
Hello, Mr. Cunningham. Alan, it's a big pot out there, buddy. I'm all in. Don't be scared.
I call.
Only a donkey would make that call.
We play at fulltiltpoker.net.
The phenomenon you are about to experience.
Folks, I'm worried that this is a play.
Has no explanation and no warning.
We need to evacuate this town.
It's too late for that.
The Weeping, now playing. At Shell, we're constantly raising the bar. That's why Shell has become the first nationally in Canada, not just to meet, but exceed the top-tier detergent gasoline standards for all gasoline grades, set by BMW, GM, Honda, and Toyota. And that's what separates Shell from ordinary fuels.
The Los Angeles Times, The New York Times, Rolling Stone, and Time Magazine are all talking. Shooter is a crowd-pleasing thriller with a ton of white-knuckle action. Mark Wahlberg hits the target.
I didn't start it, but I mean to see it through.
Shooter, now playing everywhere.
This portion of Hockey Night in Canada on CBC is brought to you by Subway Restaurants. Subway, eat fresh. The second period straight ahead here at the Pengrove Saddledome in Calgary. No score, Flames and Oilers after one. Calgary outshooting Edmonton 12-10 in that first period and winning 74% of the faceoffs. But the goalless drought for Edmonton continues now nine periods long at 192.48 in terms of minutes, which is a team record for Edmonton. But the Flames did not come out, Greg, like we thought they were going to, or like they talked they were going to do. The onslaught and lots of hitting and pressure. They did not do that in the first period, and hence they're in a scoreless tie here as we embark on the second. Yell loses his footing, played back in by Amonte. Behind the goal, Marcus Nielsen comes right out in the crease. They score on the wraparound. It hit a skate in front, and the Flames are on the board.
exactly what Calgary wanted to do to start off this second period. Get some good pressure down low, and they get a break. I believe this hits Yell's skate in front of the net. But some good pressure here as they work the puck down low behind the boards. The Oilers are in good shape defensively. It's just one-on-one play, but the cycle continues for Calgary down low. And a harmless-looking centering pass. And as you can see, Yell cuts through the crease, and I am not sure if he's going to get credit for this goal or not there. Or did it go off Schmid's skate? We'll have to wait for the official announcement. Marcus Nielsen was the player that came around from behind the net and centered the pass, and it may have hit Schmid's leg and then went in the net. Nielsen will get credit for the goal.
Marcus Nielsen with his fourth goal of the season. Last goal coming on the 24th of February against San Jose. And it's 1-0 Flames. Nielsen from Amante and Yale. That's how they officially score it. 36 seconds into this second period. Here's Hemsky with a high shot and the quick snapping reflex of Kiprusoff, and it's in his trapper.
I'll take one more look at this goal. And good work by Nielsen here to gain position on Jason Smith on the wraparound. And there it hits Smeed's left foot. There it goes in the net. Let's have another look. It's its back foot, actually. Yeah, his left toe of Schmid's that hits the puck and puts it into the net, and that will be Marcus Nielsen's goal on the wraparound.
Here's a chance in front as Hemsky goes right through the crease and couldn't tuck it in. Conroy can't get past Pisani. Hemsky sidestepping most of the check from Stewart, but the Flames will get it out. Gilbert, long reaching pass. Horkoff rink wide to Pisani now, turning in the neutral zone. And it's offside at the bench.
The Oilers are all trying to change. Now they're going to call too many men on the ice. I think they are. And the Oilers were just jammed up at the gate, and they couldn't get off the ice.
The lineup to get off.
And that's an interesting call. And as you can see, you watch over here. Right in front of the bench here. You'll see them all lined up to try and get in the door. Two Oilers jump over. And then there is the play there that draws the too many men on the ice. That's a, oh boy, I mean, you're just trying to get off the ice. You're not involved in the play. And the linesman was the official that called it right in front of the bench.
Oilers too many men at 1:23. Calgary 0-for-1 on the power play. Back to the point now. Hammerlick right along the boards. Vestalius with a hard snapshot right into the midsection of Roloson, and he hangs on.
Well, Vestalius has had quite a season for the Calgary Flames, and many are talking Lady Bing in terms of his play. 34 goals, he only has 26 penalty minutes, and he certainly is a candidate if you start looking around the National Hockey League at Lady Bing candidates.
Certainly is. Two goals in his last three games for Calgary. At the point, Fanouf with a big blast and a pad save by Roloson. Lankow now stopping at the hash marks. Gets it back to Fanouf. Fanouf quickly across to Hammerlick. He's at the dot. A shot, leg, and a glove save there off the blocker of Roloson. Horkoff chopping at it. Vesalius gets it out. And Uginla with a good chance there. Uginla now in the corner for Calgary. Leaving it. Vesalius now gets away from Horkoff, loses his footing. They get it in front, right on the stick of Lankow, and he can't pull the trigger. It's chopped out down the ice by Pisani. And Kiprusoff will play it to center ice off the stick of Vesalius. And Reisner has it. Right back down the ice as Kiprusoff will leave it for Hammerlick. Hammerlick leading the rush for the Flames up the near boards. David Moss chipping it and chasing. Lombardi trying to get there. Schmid there first for Edmonton. Off the boards and ahead to Tom Gilbert. Gilbert now playing it off the glass. And Peterson is in ahead of the puck. Here's Scott now with an update.
All right, Mark, last we checked, Colorado led Nashville 2-1, but David Leguan has just scored now for the Predators. Watch this as Leguan is sprung with a lead pass, and he'll try to beat Budaj on the backhand. Fans on it. Still, it goes in. They reviewed the goal for a while to see if it was kicked in, but it stands, and Nashville and Colorado are tied at 2 now.
1-0 here in Calgary. The Flames on the goal by Nielsen, his fourth of the season, 36 seconds into this second period. Kiprusoff in behind his own goal. Ahead to Hale, shifting it up the left side. It's dumped in. Rolison can't hang on to it. Hemsky standing in the penalty box, ready to come back on. His penalty is over. Four shots on goal for the Flames. During that power play advantage, Amonte slashing at the puck, gets it loose to Yell. Back to the point. Hale, a one-timer. Big fat rebound. It's cleared by Gilbert. Regroups inside his own corner. Now behind the goal. Dropping it for Schmid. Ladislav Schmid now turning in front of Nielsen. Here comes Amonte now on the forecheck for Calgary. Hemsky can't get it out. There's Amonte on the puck. And it squirts out over the line. Peterson leaving it for Hemsky. Hemsky dancing across the line as it picked off his stick before he could get the shot away. Jason Smith now at his own line. Quickly ahead to Sikora. Dumping into the far corner. Brad Winchester can't get there first. It comes back to Lupel on his stick. Winchester battling with Giordano. In front of the net, here's Lupel waiting. Takes a long time to get the shot away, and it's deflected over top. Winchester pile driving Giordano in behind the Flames goal. That arise out of this Calgary crowd. Lupel now cycling along with Winchester. Lupel, quick shot, misses the goal. Giordano playing it off the boards. Lupel keeps it in. Knocked off the puck. And Brad Stewart is set up behind his goal. Up the near side to Craig Conroy. Conroy now on the glass deep inside the Oilers zone. Tanguay knocked off the puck by Pouliot. Green quickly ahead to Rafi Torres. Torres to center ice, stick handling his way across the Calgary line. Tanguay knocks the puck off his stick momentarily. Still battles for it along the boards. Knocked down. Still working hard, Torres. Chip back to the point. Savret can't keep it in. Schmid to the line. Pouliot battling with Hammerlick. Is in behind the goal to Phaneuf. Phaneuf to Hammerlick. Oilers getting a change as the Flames start out. Phaneuf, long pass too far, goes right inside the zone. And it's touched by Brian Young, icing the call against Calgary.
My opinion, Jerome McGinley has had another terrific season for the Calgary Flames. Don't forget he was hurt for bits and pieces out with 12 games with that knee injury. But again, McGinley, 94 points in 69 games. Just to give you an idea of how well he has played. It would have been if he played the whole season. That was his projection, which is right up the top of the league.
Thorsson missing the one-timer in the high slot. Yes, those 12 games, the knee injury. Cutting short this season. Phaneuf knocked it along the boards. Stortini hit hard from behind by Hammerlick. Thorsson now checked by Primo. And Stortini comes up with it. Impressed by Phaneuf and Primo. Peterson plays it behind the goal. Thorsson now. Pancaked by Hammerlick. Thorsson turning in the corner. Trying to get away from the D. Gets it back. A one-timer. Didn't get all of it. Peterson as it goes into the corner. In the slot again. Too high for Thorsson. McGinley now. Quick pass on the stick of Tanguay. Tanguay dancing in front of Savret. Turning inside the Oilers zone. Savret gets his stick on it. Can't get it out. It hit the skate of a Flame player leading to the bench. Cleared down the ice. Oilers will get a change as Warrender goes back to touch up. Icing the call against Edmonton. 1-0 Calgary here in the second.
Ode to the fresh toasted Italian BMT. Piled oh so high with ham, salami, pepperoni. A tastacular trifecta of massive meatness. Tuck them into a loaf of freshly baked bread with melted processed cheese and an avalanche of crisp veggies, and you got a sandwich that has even the burliest burger questioning its manhood. Give your appetite a little TLC with a big ol' Italian BMT. Subway, eat fresh.
Here later.
Welcome to You Do Voodoo. We get thousands of orders online for cheating boyfriends, business partners. Thing is, they're heat sensitive.
No problem.
We ship coast to coast.
Coast to coast.
Coast to coast.
Pure Later's Canada's largest courier.
Delivered by 9 a.m.?
Overnight guarantee.
When you ship with Pure Later, out of the ordinary is never out of the question. Pure Later, where business is going.
Are you still drinking overpriced beer? Well, now's the time to switch to Lakeport Pilsner, Lakeport Light, or Lakeport Honey Lager. We're still 2-4 for 2-4. Lakeport, great beer, fair prices. You ask for cans, and Lakeport delivers. Lakeport Pilsner, Lakeport Light, and Lakeport Honey Lager, now in cans for the lowest legal price. That's $10 less a 2-4 than regular beer. Lakeport, great beer, fair prices.
Not sure if they've posted this out-of-town score update yet inside the Pengrove Saddle Dome, but Nashville has taken the lead over Colorado. Watch this. Forsberg to Korea. Korea the whole net to make it 3-2 Predators with about 8 to go in regulation time. And again, if Nashville wins, the Flames are in no matter what happens against the Oilers tonight. Mark.
Right, Scott, and the Flames with a 1-0 lead right now with 13:20 to go in the second period against an Oilers team that is struggling to score goals. They've got just 21 goals in their last 19 games. And that scoreless streak now approaching 10 periods.
And they've been held to one goal or less 13 of their last 18 as well. To give you an idea of how offensively challenged this young Edmonton group have been with all their injuries throughout this stretch.
18 players injured this year. Veterans like Stoll and the likes of Steos missing huge chunks of this season.
Ethan Morrow
with a shoulder.
Nice to see him this morning skating. Tells me that his shoulder's doing really well and he'll be ready to go next season, which is great news for the Oilers. He's a terrific person and a heck of a player and leader.
Missed 74 games. Eustalius tries to feed it in front, goes off the skate of Schmid. Pisani now gets it back behind the goal. Jason Smith head-manning it to Horkov. Horkov's pass hopping over the stick of Hemsky. Horkov on the forecheck, but Hale is there quickly. Back come the Flames. Eusalius up the right wing side. Lombardi playing it around the glass and deep in the corner now. Oilers can't get it past Yell as Green flails away. Now he does, ahead to Lupo. Joffrey Lupo can't get it out. Eusalius has a peek and plays it deep again. Gilbert now turning, leaving it for Sikora. And the Flames with press on the forecheck here, bottling up the Oilers in their own zone. Lupo finally plays it off the boards and out. Warner quickly right back inside the zone as Yell deflects it in the corner. Nielsen and Yell on the forecheck. Gilbert coughs it up. Here's a chance. Amade scores! A one-timer high.
And his first goal in 20 games. And young Gilbert bobbles the puck in the corner. And the Flames on a little chip and chase down the sideboards here. Gilbert goes back for the puck. A little trouble with it after the pass ends up right in his feet. You can't really blame him for that. As Green put the pass right in his feet behind the net here. And the puck goes right off the Flame player, right to Tony Amonte, who was left wide open in front. And I was kidding Tony Amonte this morning. He came down the wing and blasted a perfect shot just over the pad of Kiprusoff in the morning skate. And I said, Tony, I think it's time. He says, I feel pretty good.
Well, that 20-game drought broken here tonight. Amonte with his 10th goal. And a penalty coming here to the Oilers, a high sticking call.
Jason Smith's going to go. Tanguay was clipped on the play. It's either going to be 2 or 4. I think it's going to be 4. Yep.
It is 4.
Absolutely. So a harmless looking play by Smith as he gets the stick up. It's not intentional at all. Well, ooh, boy. Although that's not a sharp play by Jason Smith. And Tyenge sort of leans down a little bit and ends up with the puck, the stick right in his mouth.
Jason Smith off for high sticking at 8:18 of the second period. 4 minutes as the Flames go back on the power play. Hammerlin keeping it in. Lanko around the boards, past Tange for Fanuf. Tange plays it into the corner now. Aginla cycling with Lanko. Back to Aginla in the corner. Trying to get past Green. Aginla quickly to Lanko. To the point now. Hammerlin along the boards. Lanko in the corner. Can't make a play, and it squirts loose into the opposite corner. Green doesn't get there first as Fanuf pinches all the way down from the point. Now a loose puck for Edmonton. They'll get it to center. Toby Peterson now all by himself inside the Calgary zone. As it knocked off his puck, and then he's shoved into the boards by Hammerlin. Tange quickly ahead to Aginla across the line. Flames captain playing it off the skate of the official. It comes back to Fanuf. He bobbles it, keeps it in with his skate. Aginla checked from behind by Pisani. Hammerlick backing into his own zone. Fresh legs on the penalty kill on the ice as Horkoff steps on the ice for Edmonton. Cleared in behind the goal. Rollison high backhand down the ice. He'll do it himself as Brad Stewart retreats to pick it up for the Flames. Stewart now tries to get past Horkoff. He does and sends it in deep. Coming all the way around the boards. Green is there, ahead to Horkoff, and Schmid will send it right back down the ice. 2:20 to go in the Flames power play with Jason Smith serving four for high sticking. Green, a bounce pass, too far for Thorsson, deep inside the zone. Giordano now, pass is too far for his partner. Stewart ahead to David Moss. The fans getting impatient here as Giordano retreats again, plays it back behind his goal. Now the Oilers change. It'll give the Flames a chance to come out. Lombardi with a burst of speed, stopping at the half boards. Matthew Lombardi now, dropping it in the corner. Tange to Lombardi. Lombardi coming right out in front. Loose puck. Pisani tries to get it out and can't. Kept in by Stewart. A shot off the stick of Moss. Glancing into the corner now. Tange down low. Back to the point. Stewart winds and fires, and it's blocked. Toby Peterson dropping to take that shot away.
An excellent shot block there by Peterson as Stewart had his eyes set on a wide open shot.
Approaching the final minute. Nashville still leading Colorado in Denver. Hammerlin. The final minute of this Flames power play, which has not been very potent, to say the least. Chipped in behind the goal. Rollison reaching, couldn't get there. A big hit by Schmid, breaking the stick to Blanco. Here comes Savret across the line. Savret into the slot. Reisner bobbling the puck, can't get a shot. Now he's on the loose puck. Pouliot, a wrist shot, and a leg save by Kiprusoff from the high slot, and a great chance shorthanded. Final 30 seconds of this penalty kill for Edmonton. The center ice now. Tange with some speed, dangling across the line. Green knocks him off balance. It's back to the point to Fanuf. Can't get the shot away. Huselius now into the corner. Tange into the high slot, off the stick of Huselius. And it's a high stick called with 5 seconds to go in the power play, and it's coming all the way down to the Calgary end.
For all young goalies, I want to show you what Dwayne Rollison does when he's checking players around the ice. He's so ice aware. Watch his head. Whoops. Watch what he'll do when the puck's at the point. There, he looks over there to his left, look to his right, make sure that the back door's either open, if there's a player over there. That's just great ice awareness by Dwayne Rollison. He does it so well. So when the puck goes back to the point, he'll always take a quick peek over his shoulders to see who's open on either side of the net.
And Rollison didn't face a single shot in that 4 minute Calgary power play, which is now over. Jason Smith back on the ice for Edmonton. Long pass for Yell, too far for him. Icing indicated. And Smith will touch it for the whistle for Edmonton. 7:33 to go in the second. 2-0 Flames here in Calgary.
Another fresh moment from Subway Restaurants. There's nothing like a BMT sandwich from Subway Restaurants. Genoa salami, pepperoni, and ham with your choice of fresh vegetables. Served on freshly baked bread. It's the fresh taste you've been looking for. Subway. Eat fresh.
Dodge Ram. It's got a legendary Hemi V8 with 345 horsepower. An all-new 6.7-liter Cummins turbo diesel with 650 pound-feet of torque. A high-strength steel frame with fully boxed rails. Over 5,000 pounds payload available or up to 16,900 pounds of towing. Dodge Ram. The longest-lasting, most durable line of full-size pickups.
Another fresh moment from Subway Restaurants. There's nothing like a BMT sandwich from Subway Restaurants. Genoa salami, pepperoni, and ham with your choice of fresh vegetables. Served on freshly baked bread. It's the fresh taste you've been looking for. Subway. Eat fresh.
The Coors Light Brewing Company is looking for fun, energetic people interested in après-ski, loud music, dining and dashing, eating meat, short-term financial planning, road trips, and that ice-cold, easy-drinking taste. Does this sound like you or someone you know? Call now, and we'll throw in questionable office behavior. Coors Light. Who wants a cold one?
Dion Phaneuf and the Flames may not know it, but they have clinched a playoff berth in the Western Conference as J.P. Dubon has scored his second goal of the game with 24 seconds to go into the empty net. And it's 4-2, Nashville.
And a good opportunity now for Calgary tomorrow going to Colorado to maybe even leave some guys home, but certainly rest a lot of their key players to get ready for their first round matchup.
Yep.
Against the Detroit Red Wings. And that should be a dandy series, in my opinion.
Another Alberta team to face the Red Wings in the first round after the Oilers took the Wings out in six last year. The buzzer has sounded. In Denver, the game is over. A 4-2 final as Nashville came back with three unanswered goals in the third period to come from behind and end the improbable Avalanche roll and crush their playoff hopes. Yell chasing Jason Smith, reversing his field in behind the goal. He'll take it out for Edmonton, dropping it back for Horkov. Horkov feeding it up the boards. Can't reach the loose puck. Gets cleared to center. Smith hits a teammate in the ankle, and Oilers come up, or rather the Flames come up with it and send it right back in the Oilers zone. Rollison playing it around the boards. Feverish forecheck by Amate. And Sikora will get it out. His pass off the stick of Lanco. Now Pisani will play it inside the Calgary zone. Hammerlick, a rink-wide pass in full stride. Matthew Lombardi dropping it for Lanco. Lanco's pass into the slot. Two whacks at it. And Huselius couldn't find the mesh.
Closed captioning of this program is brought to you in part by Chevrolet. Let's go Chevrolet.ca.
And a reminder, with the playoffs just around the corner, Hockey Night in Canada invites you to join our playoff pool. All kinds of prizes, lots of money available, and prizes awarded for each and every round. Just sign up, go online to cbcsports.ca/playoff pool 07.
And they have just announced the score here in the building. If you're wondering why all the noise is going on, some happy Calgary fan faces.
So it's academic here tonight in Calgary. The Flames are in, and they are doing their own part with a 2-0 lead, but it doesn't matter anymore with Colorado going down to defeat 4-2 tonight at home to Nashville. And what a chase it was for Colorado down the stretch, winning 13 of their last 16 games before tonight. Here's a chance for Thorsson, splitting the defense on the backhand. Can't get the shot away. He's hooked up by David Hale. And a penalty coming here to the Flames.
No penalty shot, just a hooking call.
Hale heading off for hooking. And a power play for Edmonton when we come back.
Are you still thinking of building on a piece of land?
Well, that's the dream.
Okay, let's have a look.
What do you see in your future? A financial security advisor from Freedom 55 Financial can help you get there. Because financial security planning isn't just about retirement. It's about making things happen in every stage of your life. So keep dreaming, but start planning. We're ready when you are.
Okay, here's what we can do to help make it happen.
That's great.
Freedom 55 Financial. The freedom to choose. The power to get there.
With the innovative Rona by Design concept, it's almost that simple. Choose from among the latest in bathroom styles to suit your tastes. Then bring your dream to life with our Rona experts. Rona by Design, from the Canadian how-to people.
24-year-old Tom Gilbert, who played for the University of Wisconsin, who I think has had an excellent time here as an Edmonton Oiler, playing quite a bit, gets a perfect pass up to Thornton, who is in the clear, but gets hooked up at the last second by David Hale. So the Edmonton Oilers get to work on the power play and try and beat this goose egg that's been sitting on their scoreboard for quite some time.
That's a perfect example of what Craig McTavish was saying this morning, that he can make plays. You saw that there. Hemsky's pass for Horkoff off the stick of Warner. Gilbert has been a game star for the Oilers in three of their last five games. Matt Green back to set up and lead this rush for Edmonton. Vasani now dumping it, put himself offside at the Calgary line. Another tough season as well for Fernando Pisani, with 14 goals, 13 assists coming into this game. The playoff hero 1 year ago with 14 goals alone in the playoffs. But when he's not scoring, he has been terrific in terms of his defensive play as a forward for Edmonton.
Now he's an honest hockey player, and you know what you're going to get from him game in and game out.
Hemsky overskating the puck. He comes back to the point. Green across to Sikora. Matt Green now down the middle. Blasts it. Big rebound off the pads of Kiprusoff. Hemsky, high wire act, and scores.
Well, Craig McTavish told Hemsky the best 12 goal scorer in the National Hockey League at the moment. And with all his injuries and problems throughout the year, it's been a tough year for Hemsky, but he shows you here that when he gets good opportunities, he can really shoot the puck. What a shot. I mean, what a shot. As the puck comes off the traffic in front, Hemsky just drills it over top of Kiprusoff after Horkoff does a pretty good job of getting in the way of Kiprusoff as well, but he wasn't getting that baby anyway. I mean, Hemsky absolutely wired it for his 13th goal of the year.
On the power play to cut the Flames lead to one. And McTavish was saying this morning that nobody is good enough to do it by himself in the NHL, referring to the struggles Hemsky's had this year. And you know that a top forward to play with Hemsky will be high on the Oilers' shopping list of free agents come this summer. Here's a chance now. Wrist shot by Conroy. It's deflected high and over top of the end glass here at the Pengros Saddle Dome. Flames out shooting the Oilers 21-15. Jim Playfair, not sure if he knows yet that they're, well, he does now.
Oh, of course he does. They announced it. But he wants to play to win this game, and then tomorrow night I'm sure he'll rest some of his veteran players
You know Kiprusoff, I would doubt, will go in that game in Colorado.
And that goal breaks the scoreless drought by the Oilers, now official at 207.44 minutes, which is a dubious team record. Ginla turning at his own line. A backhand pass for Conroy across the line. Ginla's knocked off the puck by Stortini on the back check. Schmid now, blind pass right on the stick of Conroy. Conroy to Ginla, he overskates it. In the corner now. Drop pass back to Conroy in behind the goal. Jerome Ginla quickly to Conroy on the short side, and he's stopped by Rolison. Back come the Oilers. Toby Peterson now dropping it. Schmid a shot right on. And a big save by Kiprusoff on the one-timer from the defender. Dumped back inside the Oilers zone. Matt Green turning quickly up ice with the Flames changing at the line. Pouliot dropping it for Torres in the high slot as it knocked off his stick. And a penalty coming here.
We got a whole slew, I believe, of Edmonton Oilers on the ice.
There's six on the ice right now.
Yep. So they're going to get a call for too many men on the ice.
Second one tonight.
Yeah, the first one though.
Yeah.
They're just trying to change. Let's have a peek here. There's two at the bottom. Three. Four. Ooh, five. Six. And Huselius is letting everybody know, hey, too many men on the ice. And it was a good call by Huselius, and often you have to do that to make the officials aware of the situation.
Torres serving the second too many men on the ice penalty against the Oilers tonight. It comes at 16:13 of the second period. Flames 0-4 on the power play tonight. Lombardi in behind the goal to Lanco. Damon Lanco to the point. Giordano D to D. Stewart to the half boards. Salius now turning in front of Horkoff. Can't get away. Horkoff plays it back to Green, and Green will send it down the ice. The other goal from Hemsky from Green and Sikora officially at 14:56 on the power play to make it 2-1. Calgary at the line now. Salius dropping it to the point. Stewart quickly across the blue line. Giordano right back to Stewart, who touches it deep. Salius to the point. Stewart fakes the shot. Huselius now loses control, and Edmonton will send it down as Reasoner plays it off the boards. Wholesale changes with a minute to go in the power play. Moss warded off the puck by Schmidt. It's kept in at the line. Hammerlick along the boards now. Amati turning at the hash marks. Tony Amati with his first goal in 21 games. Back to the point now. Fournouf dancing along the blue line, finally can't keep it in as Thorsson chops at it. He'll regroup at his own line. Hammerlick backpedaling inside his own zone. Now right back to his goal line. Long pass ahead to Prima, who leaves it for Moss. Moss across the line with Amati. Amati in the high slot, a charging Hammerlick with a one-timer, and it's stopped by Rolison.
There's another storyline to this game. The first one was, of course, seeing if the Calgary Flames getting the playoffs there officially in. But how about the second one now, the draft lottery? Edmonton really doesn't want to win this game in a way, because the top five teams get into the draft lottery for the first pick in this year's NHL draft. And Kevin Lowell, I'm sure, is sitting there thinking, well, boys, you know, a 2-1 loss may not be all that bad, even though you want to win every game as a manager and a coach. But for the future, the Oilers certainly want to get into that draft lottery to have a better chance than one of the best kids coming up, or some of the good kids coming up in this year's draft.
Craig McTavish was talking about this morning, and he mentioned the integrity of the game, that, you know, Colorado would expect them to give their full effort. Now that Colorado has been defeated, it's academic.
Don't worry, the coach always wants to win. You never coach to lose. That's in a coach's makeup. Craig McTavish is a competitive guy. You know he wants to win this game. And the Oilers have done a good job so far. They've had several good chances to score. They just got back in it. And this sets up a pretty interesting third period, although there's still 1:48 left in period two.
Torres back on the ice. The Oiler penalty for too many men has expired. And now the Flames are 0 for 5 on the power play. Reisner, his dump pass broken up the line. In transition now, it's Iginla. Leaving it for Tanka, he cut in and the pass was out. And it's sent right back inside the Calgary zone. Icing will be the call. With 1:22 to go here in the second period.
If you just joined us, the Toronto Maple Leafs did beat the Montreal Canadiens tonight in a thriller at the Air Canada Centre, which means the Maple Leafs are hoping for a New York Islander loss tomorrow at 3:30 on TSN as they play the New Jersey Devils. You can tune into that game and see it on TSN at 3:30 tomorrow.
That'd be interesting. The Leafs with their fortunes out of their hands now. Waiting and watching. Shot thrown at the net. Warner in traffic in front. Nielsen chipping away. Richie gets it behind the goal. Yell has it knocked off his stick by Smith. Final minute of this second period. Matt Green behind the goal. Rollison ahead to Smith. And off the skate of Giordano and out of play. Terrific amount of energy in Toronto tonight, and all the Leafs can do now is sit and watch, and their fortunes now in the hands of the Islanders and the New Jersey Devils.
The Devils have not played since Thursday, so you would think they'll put Martin Brodeur in the goal regardless. I think Lou Lamoriello would do that anyway, but I am sure they want to get Marty Brodeur tuned up one more time and get him ready for the playoffs. He's the kind of goalie that likes to play and be in there. And I don't think he'd like that much time off going into game one in the playoffs.
Bussani playing it off the boards. And finally out. Schmid now. Will lug it across the line. Right on the tape of a dancing Hemsky in. A shot just missing the far post. And it goes up over the end glass for a whistle. Tomorrow on CBC, the world's top curlers go head-to-head live from Edmonton. CBC Sports has the final of the Ford World Men's Curling Championship. It's Canada's Glenn Howard and Germany's Andy Kapp tomorrow beginning at 1:30 p.m. Eastern on CBC television. 29.3 seconds to go here in the second period of a 2-1 hockey game. Once again, they can't get the puck dropped, and Yell is tossed from the circle. Draw back to the point. Gilbert plays it into the corner. Off the stick of Hemsky. Gilbert now down low, tries to chip it into the slot, battling behind the Flames goal. Amati has it knocked off his stick. Bussani on the loose puck. 15 seconds to go in the period. Fernando Bussani deep, back to the point. Wrist shot, they score! Ladislav Schmid, top corner again.
Well, Schmid let the shot go, and it almost fooled Kiprusoff here. It was a funny-looking shot. Bussani, with some very good work against Phaneuf, turns back now, throws the puck behind the net. Schmid sneaks in from the point, and I'm not sure if Kiprusoff saw this puck or it hit Stefan Yell on the way through. But it definitely fooled the goaltender Kiprusoff. He's well out. And that just got the short side on Mika Kiprusoff. We got a 2-2 game.
Ladislav Schmid with his third goal of the season with just 9 seconds to go in the period. The tie it at 2 as the horn sounds to end the second period of play. Schmid from Gilbert and Bussani at 19:50. And we're all tied at 2 as Calgary outshoots Edmonton 22-18.
This portion of Hockey Night in Canada on CBC is brought to you by Subway Restaurants. Subway, eat fresh.
Ode to the fresh toasted Italian BMT, piled oh so high with ham, salami, pepperoni, a tastacular trifecta of massive meatness. Tuck them into a loaf of freshly baked bread with melted processed cheese and an avalanche of crisp veggies, and you got a sandwich that has even the burliest burger questioning its manhood. Give your appetite a little TLC with a big old Italian BMT. Subway, eat fresh.
Oilers hanging in after two. They're tied at two with the Calgary Flames. Here's Sean Horkoff. Sean, how would you describe your feelings over the Oilers season ending some 2 months earlier than it did last year, now that the moment is almost upon you?
Well, it's obviously frustrating. I think obviously after the success that we had in the postseason last year, we had high hopes coming into this season, and with not being able to make the playoffs and get back to, you know, giving ourselves at least a chance of getting back to where we were last year is obviously frustrating. But as of now, you know, we've got a lot of injuries this year, and there's a lot of guys on the team, that play quality minutes are gonna really use the rest.
You're not gonna have the opportunity, obviously, to spoil things for the Calgary Flames tonight as Nashville finished off Colorado. But what was the Oilers' mindset heading into this game tonight?
Well, it wasn't so much, I mean, even playing spoilers. We just wanted to come in and play a good, solid last game and try to take some confidence and belief into into the off season. I think, like I said, for us, it's we're gonna have a lot of time off, but we're gonna be able to do a lot of work in the off season that's gonna be able to get us back to where we were last year.
Thanks, Sean.
Okay, thanks, Scott.
There's Sean Horkoff of the Edmonton Oilers. Stand by for Scoreboard Saturday. That's up next here at the Saddle Dome. Vladislav Schmid has the Oilers on even terms with the Flames. It's 2-2 after two.
Today, Tom Nanos planted life. Mark Melanson added some life. Nisha Malhotra's team created a life-saving idea. Today, Sophie LeMay inspired a winner. Joanna Saunders knew she was a winner. Anthony Creighton learned how to make his legs work. Steve Walker learned how it all works. Today, Aimard Angulo made the world a little greener. While Carl Ditchin made the air around it a little cleaner. Wonder what they'll do tomorrow to make things better. Toyota, make things better.
Flying to the same places over and over? Check out our new flight passes, good for multiple flights. Air Canada, the freedom to fly your own way.
Mad Money bonus checks have arrived. Just in time for the legendary Midnight Madness sale at the Brick. Get your $300 Mad Money bonus check until Sunday only. Shop today and save an extra $300 on furniture and mattresses. The sale prices throughout the store. Plus, you don't pay for 15 months. The Brick's legendary Midnight Madness sale. Get your $300 Mad Money bonus check or shop online at thebrick.com. Hurry, it ends Sunday. Don't miss it.
What happens when people work to make sure nothing happens?
Scoreboard Saturday. Scoreboard Saturday on Hockey Night in Canada.
This is how the Calgary Flames are rewarding every one of their season ticket holders. They're all getting one of these. It's called a lenticular. It's a nice 3D effect, and that's Mika Kiprusoff featured on it.
And the photographer is Jerry Thomas, good friend of ours. He's a fantastic sports photographer. This is the first one in professional sports, Scott.
All right, let's go around the league, beginning with the Colorado Avalanche, Kelly, who went 14-2-2 since the trade deadline, and because of this loss to Nashville, they've missed the playoffs. The Flames are in.
You know what, Scott? Had they had good goaltending early on in the season, I personally believe Colorado would have not had any problem whatsoever being in the playoffs.
All right, Canucks at San Jose, the Northwest Crown there for Vancouver's taking. Canucks got the jump with a couple of quick goals. 4:30 gone in the first from Taylor Pyatt. A deflected Sammy Salo shot from the point. 2-0 Canucks.
Pyatt's back. He had a bit of a slump in early March, but he's playing a little bit better now.
Penalties hurt Vancouver 48 seconds into the second period. Canucks shorthanded. Joe Thornton's shot goes off Luongo and in off Malamihalik's leg. Sharks within one at 2-1. With 4:18 remaining in the period, Sharks cash in on the man advantage again. It's Thornton, and it's 2-2.
That's going to be an issue, those lively boards in the playoffs.
Canucks convert on a power play of their own in the third. Kevin Bieksa's bullet from the point makes it 3-2. By the way, he left the arena in a walking cast, but we're told he'll be good to go in the
That's
playoffs.
That's his 12th, too. That's a great season.
Jonathan Chichu tied the game with 33 seconds left in regulation, so on to OT. We're 34 seconds in. The Canucks on the power play. Matthias Olin delivers Vancouver to the Northwest title, 4-3, the final.
And again, that's Curtis Brown, a good veteran, trying to deflect the puck from Olin, and yet he deflects it behind his own goalie, Nabokov.
So it's a Vancouver-Dallas opening round matchup. Winner take all in Toronto tonight. At least the Canadians would. Leafs would require some help from New Jersey tomorrow. Second period, Canadians within one at 3-2, 5-on-3 here. Michael Ryder scoring on the rebound to make it 3-3. And that really rattled the Leafs. Ryder on fire here. He jams in his third to complete the natural hat trick in 5:49.
And I'm sure Maurice didn't want to pull Raycroft, but he had no choice knowing that he needed to change the momentum.
5:30 to go in the second. Canadiens on the power play, and Chris Higgins' carom shot good for his second of the game, and a 5-3 Montreal lead. Leafs get one back about 3 minutes later. A pinball shot from Carlo Koliakovo. Leafs within one at 5-4. Third period, less than a minute old. Leafs 5-on-3. McCabe finally elects to shoot. Game tied at 5.
He weighed way too deep in that play.
A few minutes later, smart play by Thomas Cabrelet. He waits for Tucker and Wellwood to set up the screen. Wellwood gets the goal.
You know what, Scott?
I think that
went in off his arm. It could have even been his hand. I'm not sure.
But no review. So the Leafs, remember, had to beat the Canadiens in regulation time, and they hung on to do it. 6-5 the final in a high-stakes game, Kelly, that almost defied hockey logic.
I thought they had no chance when it's 5-3 Montreal.
If New Jersey beats the Islanders tomorrow afternoon, Leafs are in.
That's in Jersey, too.
At 4 o'clock, ET. Ottawa-Pittsburgh series is set. Brian Murray's Sens could clinch home ice with a win in Boston. Bruins open the scoring. Marco Sturm beats Ray Emery 1:28 into the game. Sturm's 27th.
Having a rebound season.
Senators respond a few minutes later. Mike Comrie's 20th from Peter Schaefer, and it's 1-1. And boy, Mike Comrie has found a home in Ottawa.
Yeah, well, he's a skilled player, and he just has to be in a role that he's not counted upon to be the number one or two centerman.
Bruins' two-goal lead restored at 5:57 in the first. It was Peter Kalas from Donovan and Savard, so 2-1 Bruins.
Big rebound by Emery.
Spezza, Heatley, Alfredson, huge for the Sens. Here, Spezza gets his first of two on the night to pull Ottawa into a 2-2 tie. Assist to Alfredson and Phillips.
Wow.
Just over 5 minutes into the second, Danny Heatley set up by Alfredson, and Mazzaro scores number 50. Second straight year he's reached that plateau.
Gave him way too much room. If he has that much time to wind up and slap it by somebody, not many goalies are going to make that save.
So 3-2 there, soon to be 4-2, and again it's Spezza, second of the game for him, 34 in the season. Schubert and Heatley the assists. Sens go on to a 6-3 win and ensure that they have home ice to start their series with Pittsburgh, and we think it's on Wednesday night.
Now they have to learn how to deal with the pressure. Pittsburgh has no pressure right now. It's all on Ottawa.
Here's how Ted Nolan's Islanders stayed alive in the East as they stormed to a 3-0 lead. I guess we're not going to see highlights of that game. Thought we would, but anyway, it's a 4-2 final for the Islanders. So they finished the afternoon hoping for the Leafs to beat Montreal in regulation, because that combined with an Islanders win over New Jersey, as we say tomorrow, would give the number 8 spot to the Isles, and that possibility still exists.
And Dubowitz has been really good, actually kind of surprising.
Buffalo shut out Washington 2-0 to wrap up the President's Trophy with their 53rd win of the season. Tim Connelly scored his first goal in a year. Ryan Miller recorded just his second shutout.
That's surprising with all the wins.
Michael Samuelson had a 5-point game in Detroit's 7-2 win over Chicago. Detroit in the playoffs for the 16th consecutive season. Chicago out for the 8th time in 9 seasons.
That's a good way to finish for Detroit, because they've been a little sloppy lately.
Anze Kopitar scored his 20th with 53 seconds left in regulation. LA beat Phoenix 3-2.
He's going to be a superstar in this game.
Carolina beats Florida 5-4 in OT. Rod Brind'Amour with the winner. Hurricanes had a record, a team record, 53 shots in that game.
Wow. Disappointing seasons for both, though.
Atlanta beats Tampa 3-2 in a shootout. Lightning miss a chance to move into the number 6 seed position. They finish 7 and will face New Jersey.
I'm sure Tampa's concerned about their goaltending. At this point, they don't really have a number 1 guy.
Anaheim 4-3 over Columbus. Timo Salani with a pair. Ducks had clinched the Pacific Division earlier in the day, with San Jose being held to that single point by Vancouver.
And Columbus is not going to be a bad team next year.
Pittsburgh beats the Rangers 2-1, but Ottawa's win over Boston keeps the Penguins in the number five position.
I could see both these teams going deep in the playoffs. They're both playing extremely well right now.
Minnesota 5-1 over St. Louis in a game rendered meaningless for the Wild, with Vancouver clinching the Northwest earlier in the day.
What a series that's going to be. Minnesota-Anaheim.
So here are the Stanley Cup playoff tournament matchups as we know them for Canadian teams. It's either Toronto or the Islanders at Buffalo to open, Pittsburgh at Ottawa, Calgary at Detroit as a result of Nashville finishing off Colorado tonight, and Dallas will open at Vancouver on Wednesday night. It's Tampa at New Jersey, the Rangers at Atlanta, Minnesota at Anaheim, and San Jose will open the Stanley Cup tournament for the second consecutive year against the Nashville Predators. Here at the Pengrowth Saddle Dome, it's 2-2 between the Flames and the Oilers after 2 on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Blades of Glory is hysterical and outrageously funny.
Here's a new quote for you.
The New York Times says Will Ferrell is a ferocious marshmallow.
I don't even know what that means.
No one knows what it means, but it's provocative.
Blades of Glory.
Now playing.
Hey, I'm Mark Jackson. This Tuesday, a brand new episode of This Hour has 22 minutes with lots of fun. Ow! Ow! Ow, don't use that one. I think I banged my pickle.
Mike!
Who's counting on your breaks today? Your brakes are too important to trust to just anyone. Visit Midas for lifetime brake pads or shoes, just $49, installation extra. We'll provide a written estimate and fully explain any additional work needed. Be safe.
Just the Midas touch.
Expedia.ca presents Lesson 1, Conversing in Italy.
Ciao. Perché sei così bella? Cosa ti ha portato a Roma? Il vento? Le stelle?
The stars? No. The Great European Vacation Sale? Yeah. Right now, your perfect European vacation is on sale. Just choose your flight and the hotel of your dreams, and presto, we'll get you there.
Aspetta! Vengo con te!
Expedia.ca. Your trip, your way.
And now, the bride's bouquet!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
Have you had your moment today? Have you had a flash, a flicker, a split second in time where you felt completely and utterly alive? Have you had your moment today? Would you like to? The 306 horsepower Lexus IS350. Lexus. Pursue the moment.
Our Kia Rondo pool is closed now, so next up for you and us is our playoff pool. Lots of cash prizes on the line here, merchandise as well. You can go online to enter and contend perhaps for the $20,000 first prize money, prizes awarded after each round. Heading for the third in Calgary with the Flames and Oilers on even terms, Mark Lee and Greg Millen on the other side of the break.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Lakeport Pilsner, Lakeport Light, and Lakeport Honey Lager.
Lakeport, great beer, fair prices.
A Boeing 767 jet. Normally it has 245 seats. So when you try to redeem your travel reward points, why does this happen? With an RBC Avion card, you can redeem for any seat on any airline. RBC uses your points to buy seats. So if a seat's available, you're flying.
Getting our seats, it's how RBC puts us first.
Come on already, let's go!
You don't drive like her, so why are you paying the same insurance premiums as her?
If you're over 50 with a good driving record, you could save up to $400 per year on your car insurance through Grey Power. Because at Grey Power, we believe that if you're over 50 and have a good driving record, you've earned the right to save. You could save up to $400 per year. Insure your car and your home through Gray Power and save even more.
I'm nobody important. I'm just
you don't drive like her, and you shouldn't pay the same insurance premiums as her. If you're over 50 with a good driving record, it's time to reap the rewards. So call now. You could save up to $400 per year. Even if your premiums have dropped recently, you could still save through Gray Power. Call now and get the power of 50 plus.
Call 1-866-473-9637 or go to graypower.com.
With new ways to personalize your travel, our airline feels like your airline. Air Canada, the freedom to fly your own way.
All right, you've been asking for it en masse, and you're going to get it Monday night, an encore presentation of our primetime special. Big-time star Mark Wahlberg and Hero Master Corporal Paul Franklin. That's Monday on The Hour.
Stay in the loop with The Hour on CBC Television.
Flames General Manager Daryl Sutter looking from on high here at the Pengrove Saddle Dome as we get set to start the third period, his team heading to the playoffs to face Detroit in the first round.
I wonder if they'll even take a player like Kiprusoff to Colorado tomorrow and tire him out. If I was Daryl, I'd be looking for a goalie, even if I had to find a goalie from the beer league around here to back up Jamie McLennan in that game to give Kiprusoff some rest.
Yes, they'll make the late night flight to Denver. Probably won't get into the Mile High City until 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning to play out game 82 tomorrow against Colorado, a meaningless game following the Avalanche 4-2 defeat tonight at home to Nashville. A 2-2 tie here to start this third period. All the scoring coming in that second period, with Calgary jumping up to a 2-0 lead on the goals by Nielsen and Amonte, and then Edmonton coming back to tie it up on goals by Hemsky and Schmid. At the point now, Brian Young plays it off the side of the goal. That snuck through everything and just missed low. In the corner now, Winchester, a one-timer chance in the slot by Sikora. Turned aside by Kiprusoff.
What a save. My goodness, is he sharp and ready to go for the playoffs.
Danny Savrat, the former Londonite, Memorial Cup champion from 2 years ago, getting some playing time in the last month of this season. A bounce pass to the line, dumped in by Peterson. Oilers will change as Hale headmans the puck up the right side off the stick of Damon Lanko. He turns around and slashes Thorson, who goes down to one knee, but nobody saw it among the officials. Quick pass up the near boards. Zach Stortini. Ahead too far for Peterson. A bouncing puck gloved and cleared by Stewart. Wayne Primeau can't get it down ice. He's eased body checked by Green. Peterson, a back pass to Tom Gilbert. Jumping in the play, leaves it for Pouliot. Pouliot, a shot deflected high and wide. Pouliot battling with Hale. He gets it ahead to Huselius. And Huselius will carry it up to the neutral zone. Ahead to Conroy, who dumps and chases as the Flames change. Craig Conroy on the forecheck. It's kept in as Pouliot tried to bat it out of the air. In behind the goal, Rolison plays it back around the boards to the corner. Back to the point. Hammerlick a shot, just missing the net. Gimla chasing the rebound. Torres there first ahead to Reisner. A back pass smartly out to Pouliot. Marc-Antoine Pouliot waiting. A soft shot right on, and the angle cut off by Kiprusoff. Chance to check our Kia Rondo game file.
Well, Nielsen and Amonte finally get on the board for the Calgary Flames after some goalless droughts that they've been going through. Stepanyel with a couple of assists, and Edmonton finally break their scoreless drought also.
Yes, nearly 10 periods of hockey without a goal before Hemsky broke that drought. Pisani in behind the Flames goal in the corner now. Back to Hemsky. He plays it right back to Horkoff. Too far for him. Young pinching but couldn't keep it in. The puck bouncing to center ice. Hemsky back, twisting and turning for Edmonton. Hemsky, a long pass to a wide open Pisani. Pisani back to the left wing. Brian Young plays it around the boards. The near boards now. Byron Richie's pass hits Primo. Here's a chance for Lupo. Lupo off the goalpost as he beats Kiprusoff but couldn't find the mesh.
That's the kind of season Lupo's had.
Very
terrific release. Great shot, but it goes off the post. Instead of going off the post and in, it goes off the post and wide.
He has his point total virtually cut in half this year from last in Anaheim. Loose puck now is Nielsen tries to make the turn. Yell cycling with Nielsen. Plays it back for Amonte. Amonte in front. The one-timer just missed by Marcus Nielsen. Sikora plays it off the glass and chasing now. Kiprusoff. Warner off the stick of Sikora. He takes his man down as Sikora falls to the ice. Tortini pinching along the boards. Can't keep it in. Yell dumping it inside the Oilers zone. Calgary changing on the fly as Patrick Thorsen picks up the loose puck. Taking it out of his zone to center ice for Edmonton. Again, the Oilers dumping and chasing. Kiprusoff plays it right back along the glass. Kept in at the line by Gilbert. A bouncing puck. Tortini flips it ahead into the corner, into the slot. Toby Peterson stopped on the blocker save by Kiprusoff. Oilers getting more chances here in the opening 5 minutes of this third period. Trying to end the season on a winning note. Gilbert, a long shot, loose puck in front. Peterson can't get the rebound. It's cleared to the corner. Lombardi now up the far boards. Checked by Matt Green. Hammerlick up the near board, dumping it inside the Edmonton zone. Lombardi battling along the far boards with Torres. Torres wins that one. Gilbert coming right back up the boards, plays it around behind. Puglia back behind the goal to Green. Green steps out from the forecheck to center ice, dumping it back inside the Calgary zone. Kiprusoff plays it right back but not out. Zivret quickly there to keep it in for Edmonton. In behind the goal now. Torres in the slot from the point. A shot from Young doesn't get through. Here's Torres on the loose puck. Back to Brian Young. Deflected. Oh, what a leg save. And he holds on as Kiprusoff was off balance.
And Brian Young almost got his first National Hockey League goal as he shoots the puck through traffic from the point. It hits about three things on the way in. Legs and Kiprusoff. Boy, he's been sharp. He has been so sharp in this game. And Torres throws it back to Young. There is the shot. Oh, what a reaction by Kiprusoff to get his right pad on the puck after the puck redirected in the slot. And that's just great reflexes, period.
20-year-old Brian Young from Ennismore, Ontario, helped Peterborough Petes to the OHL title 1 year ago. Here's a chance now at the other end. Tanguay off the goalpost, right through the crease. And a hooking call coming here to Edmonton.
Young's going to get the penalty for hooking in front. As somehow this puck went right through Dwayne Rolison. And Young had to draw the penalty on the play afterwards. Here's some good speed through the neutral zone for Ginley. He'll throw it across. And there's that back play. You can see Rolison overplayed the puck, and that is hard to believe. And then right in front is a penalty as Young saves a goal after Moss is going right towards the net. Tanguay here with a little backhand direct after Wayne Rolison was caught off balance playing the initial rush.
It's the second time he's done that tonight. Throwing it on the backhand. Back to the point, kept in by Giordano. To the half board. Daly is trying to avoid a ferocious penalty kill. Green on him along with Peterson. Loose puck now. Pouliot reaching for it. It squirts through the high slot to the near boards at the point now. Tanguay plays it back down deep. Here's a chance for Ginla. Couldn't find the handle and took a shot from Peterson. And the Oilers will clear it. David Moss had a tap in, he thought, for a goal there. And the hookup from Young foiling that. Flames back inside the zone. Giordano to the half boards. Ginla has it knocked off his stick, trying to hold on to it, gets it to the point. Giordano has it come just outside the line, and it's offside.
And Gittle has had an off game. He hasn't done all that much in the hockey game. He looks like he's been a little bit off. And you have to wonder when he'll break out. He just needs one shot a night the way he can shoot the puck.
Didn't skate this morning and comes into this game with 40 points in his last 25. And 9 in the last 4. But you're right, he's been fighting the puck all night. 108 to go in the Calgary power play. 0 for 5 tonight, the Flames with the extra man. Hammerlick will start the rush. A backhand pass to Lombardi, tries to split the defense. Meade got a piece of the puck. In the corner now. In behind the goal. Moss back to the point. Brad Stewart back to David Moss. In the corner for Lombardi to Amonte. All the way back to the point. Stewart, D to D. Hammerlick shadowed by Reisner, who comes up with the puck for Edmonton and will start back down the ice with Thorsson. Patrick Thorsson now trying to go wide, cutting inside and stick check by Stewart. Back come the Flames. Lombardi at the line with Amonte. Plays it to Amonte in the corner. Stewart down low in the crease. A shot into the pads of Rolison. He lost his balance and managed to keep it out. Lombardi turning at the boards, back to the point. Hammerlick takes the shot. Lombardi drags it. High shot. Rebound to Amonte at the side of the goal. Back to the point now. Stewart. Young on the ice. Power play over. Lombardi faking the shot. Goes into the corner. Dropping it. Back to the point now. Stewart looks. Fires. Doesn't get through as Reisner got a block shot high. Pass doesn't get through again as Thorsson plays it softly down the ice, and the Oilers will change. Two shots on goal for the Flames, now 0 for 6 on the power play. Aginla in the corner. Horkoff badgering him in behind the goal. Gilbert comes up with it, gets it ahead to Hemsky. Les Hemsky now with Horkoff joining the rush. Hemsky high. Pisani, a shot that misses the goal. Great pass to the high forward. And Hemsky missed the net. Here comes Tanguay in the slot. Doesn't get through to Aginla. As Pisani came back to break it up. Now Hemsky, as this game begins to open up, has to wait for it. Turning at center ice. Les Hemsky with fresh troops goes in on net. Has it poked off his stick. Danny Sevret playing it around the boards. Winchester. Body checked from behind by Yell, and it's cleared back down the ice inside the Edmonton zone. Schmid loses his balance and Rolison has to make the play for him. The Oilers will send it right back down on the Calgary goal. Phaneuf now, bounce pass, tipped ahead to Stefan Yell. He's got Richie with him. Yell in the corner. Working against Young, plays it behind the goal to Richie. Marcus Nielsen now at the circle. Right back into the corner. Byron Richie tries to come out in front of Sikora. High slot pass for Nielsen. And the Oilers will get it out. Sikora trying to chip it free all by himself. And Richie will have it for Calgary. Byron Richie now by himself, cutting through the neutral zone, fighting in front of Young. A loose puck that goes right through the slot on the pass from Lanco. Torres will take it to center ice. Pass into the skates of Pouliot. It's cleared inside the zone. Torres now in the corner. Plays it back and just out as Sevret couldn't reach it in time. Matt Green backing up inside his own zone. A pass off a skate and into the Edmonton bench. 2-2 Flames and Oilers with 9:50 to go here in the third period in Calgary.
At $21,695. Kia, the power to surprise.
22 minutes. Beat that.
You're on.
Need more power?
Get today's most innovative new mowers at the Home Depot. And now we've added Cub Cadet to our exclusive lineup of great brands, including the ingenious new Zero Turning Radius mower.
The Home Depot. You can do it, we can help.
Good luck, buddy.
Don't let the good times pass you by. Get it in gear at Mazda's Get It In Gear sales event with incredibly low purchase financing and lease offers on Mazda 3, Mazda 5, and the Mazda 6 family. Plus, the first payment's on us when you lease or finance any new Mazda. Get it in gear. First payment's on us. See your dealer today.
Well, we thought Dwayne Roloson would be fresh and ready for this game, and he has been very good in goal. He gets a bit of a break here. Stewart's wide open in front of the net after the puck hits Roloson in the pads. He can't find the handle. Good play by Jason Smith to box out Brad Stewart.
Well, a celebratory atmosphere here at the Pengrove Saddle Dome with the Flames headed to the playoffs.
It'll be a great series, in my opinion, against the Detroit Red Wings.
Torres winds, and Giprashoff will hold on, cutting the angle. But it's been a sorry season since they traded Ryan Smith from Edmonton.
Well, it's a good news, bad news scenario in a way. I mean, you never want to see a record like this if you're on the Edmonton Oilers side. They were out of the playoffs when they did trade Ryan Smith. The good news is that because of their record, they may sneak into the draft lottery, depending on what happens tonight. And that would be a huge bonus for the organization, getting a high draft pick in this year's NHL draft.
What a tale of two seasons, though. The Oilers finishing this season on a six-game road trip. Their last home game was March 24th, a 4-0 loss to Nashville. Greg, last season, remember, their last home game was game six of the Stanley Cup Final. A 4-0 win over Carolina on June 17th, 3 months later than this year.
Well, I think it all started when they lost Pronger and they could never replace him. How could you in terms of a puck-moving defense? And that was one of the big problems all year for the Oilers. They just couldn't seem to get the puck up from defense to forward in a hurry, and their transition game hurt it from it. And then the injury started, and boy, did they start. But you know this team and organization will be back. No doubt about that.
There's a chance now. Sivret at the goal. They score. Thorsson on the back door. Pounds it in. 3-2 Edmonton. Speaking of proud organizations.
And an end then rushes a 3-on-3. The Flames should be all right, but they lose the battle there on the 1-on-1. And then again lose it to the net. And there's Phaneuf. Thornton walks around him, and a give and go between Horkoff and Thornton. And at that point, Phaneuf never gets back in time after he loses his man at the blue line. Kiprasov, no chance. And the Edmonton Oilers here have a 3-2 lead.
Patrick Thorsson with his fourth goal of the season. And it's a one-goal margin for Edmonton with 8.5 minutes to go here in the third period. Winchester now hassled by Nielsen and Yell. It comes back to the point. Brad Stewart throws it just wide of the goal. Amahe now along the near boards. Tries to play it back inside. Sikora bats it out of the air, and Lukl drifts it in and takes a hit from Yell.
Well, the good news for the Oilers, they're up in this game and they've played very, very well. The bad news is they just put themselves out of the draft lottery at the moment.
Horkoff, a shot that's wide.
Now 6 from the bottom if they win this game.
Yes, out of that bottom 5 in the lottery. Kamsky chips it ahead. Horkoff knocked from behind by Hale, and Yell comes up with it.
You wonder what Kevin Lowe is thinking right now. I'm sure he's proud of his troops, but.
Yeah, it's not an important game anymore, and it could cost them an important place in that lottery. In behind the goal, Lombardi has it knocked off his stick by Jason Smith. Smith, a backhand pass to Pisani, smartly onto the stick of Hemsky, who goes around Warner, turning inside the line. Hemsky dangling now, ahead in the slot, a one-timer chance by Torres, denied by Kiprusoff.
What a second effort by Kiprusoff as he reaches back to save the goal.
And how about Hemsky, fancy through the neutral zone to set that up. Here they come again. Reisner now to Torres, stopping inside the line, a backhand pass to Pouliot. In behind the net, Reisner knocked down, and the Flames come up with it. Giordano up the right wing. All by himself now, Ginla waiting for fresh legs on the ice, and Pouliot will take that pass in the midsection. Ahead to Reisner. Reisner across the blue line will dump it, and the Oilers will change. Alex Tanguay now. Stick handling his way past Thorsson. Now Stortini across the line. Pass too far for Conroy, and it comes back to center ice. Hammerlick hammers it right back in on the glass deep. Tom Gilbert is there. Smart pass to Green, and they come out nicely. Peterson to the left wing side. Thorsson again. Thorsson with Phaneuf. A shot on the short side that just misses. Peered back around the board. Zach Thorsson. Stortini now giving chase. Byron Ritchie plays it back deep. Hammerlick around the boards. Calgary changing, kept in by Stortini. Peterson, a back pass through his legs. And Thorsson will play it deep and change. Hammerlick now for Calgary to center ice. Sending it inside the zone over the stick of Rolison. David Moss on it for the Flames. In back behind the goal. Wayne Primo turning behind the net. Loses the puck. Now picks it up. Moss back and forth to Primo. Sikora battling him. Sikora shadowing Wayne Primo with Moss in behind the goal and Tom Gilbert. And Sikora comes up with it and plays it around the ice and down into the Calgary zone. Stewart, a long pass to Ritchie. Can't hold on to it at the Edmonton line. Schmid dropping it and takes a hit. Jason Smith dumping it to center ice. Oilers with a 3-2 lead with under 5 minutes to go now in this third period. Torres with some jump, chips it in. Along the boards now, kept in at the line. Jason Smith's shot hits Amati, shin pads into the corner for Pouliot. Pouliot to the point, through the skate of Smith, a race for it, and Amati had it chipped off his stick by Jason Smith. Flames backtracking, setting up, a long pass to center ice, and is dumped in by Marcus Nielsen. Amati and Nielsen on the forecheck. Young Brian Young gets it on the boards ahead to Pisani, too far. The shot from Giordano goes off the stick of Nielsen. Young now using his physical play. He's one of the best open ice hitters in the OHL. In front! Oh, and a great chance for a pinching Giordano. Denied. Amati, his pass broken up. Horkoff with a chance, a high shot. Blocker saved by Kiprusoff into the corner. Brett Warner now. Start up the left side. Giordano, a long pass, too far. And he goes inside the order zone. Rolison plays it behind to Young. Takes the hit from Primo, but makes the pass. Sivret now. Youngsters getting lots of ice time for Edmonton here in the third. Stortini can't get around. Hammerlick in the corner now, pinned along the boards. Still moving it, though. Back to the point. Thorsson to Sivret. A shot deflected by Peterson. And a save by Kiprusoff. Phaneuf with a shoulder on Stortini. His third line working hard. And a short angle, sharp shot there. Stopped by Kiprusoff as there's some pushing and shoving in front of the Calgary netminder.
Gentlemen, we've got the puck. We've also got defenders, the goalie, and a whole lot of real estate between us and that net.
We're going for a breakaway. Let's move.
You are simply not working hard enough! We need full power!
Focus, give us a target.
Target acquired. Glove side.
Standing by.
Let her go. All right, keep your shorts on, gentlemen. We gotta hydrate.
The Coors Light Brewing Company is looking for fun, energetic people interested in après-ski, loud music, dining and dashing, eating meat, short-term financial planning, road trips, and that ice-cold, easy-drinking taste. Does this sound like you or someone you know? Call now and we'll throw in questionable office behavior. Coors Light, who wants a cold one?
Young Giordano had a real good chance in the slot moments ago. Dwayne Rollison, who's been great, Lanco throws it behind the net. And Tange, who sees the ice so well, finds Giordano sneaking in from the point. What a save. And at the other end, boy, we've seen some great goaltending tonight. And Kiprasov makes an excellent save here as he reaches back and robs Torres.
Wow.
And that just shows you the ability of Kiprasov to stay with saves and keep his eye on the puck at all times.
Brian Young plays it behind the goal to Lupel. Lupel, bounce pass, can't reach it, and Conroy has it. Up the left wing, Warner. Back on the right side to Alex Tange, and it's offside at the Edmonton line.
So we're seeing a lot of Young on the blue line now. Savret is playing. They're playing together at the moment against the Jerome McGinley line with Conroy. Interesting. There's a cheer. Lanny McDonald is being shown up on the rink video board.
Brian Young battling with Aginla. It's kept in at the line. Warner's shot blocked by a dropping Winchester. Conroy, quick shot, and that was rapier-like as it hit Rollison in the chest as he makes the save to hold on to this one-goal lead.
Thanks, Ontario, for switching to Lakeport Pilsner, for making Lakeport Light the fastest-growing light beer, and for making Lakeport Honey Lager the number one honey beer. We're still 2-4 for 2-4. Lakeport, great beer, fair prices. You ask for cans, and Lakeport delivers. Lakeport Pilsner, Lakeport Light, and Lakeport Honey Lager, now in cans for the lowest legal price. That's $10 less a 2-4 than regular beer. Lakeport, great beer, fair prices.
Looking for the right mortgage? Come to TD Canada Trust, where we'll help you find a mortgage that has everything you're looking for, which could make all the difference.
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide.
Get the mortgage that's right for you. TD Canada Trust. Banking can be this comfortable.
All right, then. Let's go.
I love it.
Let me try. I love it too.
The Suzuki Drive It Love It event. 0% purchase financing for 48 months on all 2007 models, like the SX4, Grand Vitara, and XL7. The Drive It Love It event at your local Suzuki dealer.
Back in Calgary in the Ed Whalen broadcast booth with Greg Millen and David Moyer. I'm Mark Lee. 2:34 to go in this third period. A 3-2 Oilers lead. But look ahead to the playoffs, though. It's Calgary and Detroit in the first round, and they were 2-2 this year during the regular season. A reminder, CBC News presents live coverage of the dedication of the Canadian National Vimy Memorial from Vimy, France, and Ottawa. It all begins tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern. Conroy back to the point. Giordano shadowed there by Torres. Couldn't find an alley. Plays it behind the goal. Here's a chance from the side. A glove save by Rollison on Aginla. His best chance of the game. Another shot right on. And Rollison will hold on.
Well, you look ahead of that series, and in this building, Calgary had great success this year against the Detroit Red Wings. How did they win? Well, they got in their face. They played that very aggressive, grinding style that they can play. Wore down the Detroit Red Wings, and in my opinion, if they play like that, they're going to give them a goal. What a goalie battle we're going to see, too, as Hasek against Kiprusoff. Should be an exciting series.
Yes, Calgary winning 4-1 and 2-1 during the season against Detroit, losing 7-4 and 3-2. 2-2 the season series as they get set to square off in round one.
Not quite sure yet when that is going to start, as of course the broadcasters have to get involved in all those decisions, the rights holders.
The last word I heard was it could start as late as Friday.
Well, I believe NBC has their eye on that series also with the Detroit Red Wings. So again, all those decisions have not been made yet. I'm sure they will be made in the next 24 hours.
1:57 to go in this hockey game in regulation, a 3-2 Oiler lead. And again, these youngsters are getting lots of time on defense, Sivret and Young. Pass ahead for Lupo. They get it out. Sikora jumping on the puck. Yell there first to play it to his partner. Yell gets the return pass. It's broken up by Lupo. Back inside the Calgary zone.
We haven't seen a lot of Jason Smith on the defense in this period. Schmid, we've hardly seen at all.
Icing the call against Calgary with 1:27 to go. And again, an Edmonton win here tonight will leave them with the sixth worst record and leave them out of that bottom five lottery for the all-important pick positions in the draft this summer.
So it's a good win for the Oilers if they can hold this lead. But, and by the way, a point won't do it either, because it'll be tied with Washington. Then it would go down to wins, and the Oilers have more wins than the Capitals. And now we're going to get a penalty here.
And Amonte
got it right
in
the face.
And now there's some mixing going in the circle, but Amonte is writhing on the ice right near the Calgary bench.
And Phaneuf wants a piece of Stortini. That's right.
Stortini loves to beak off and stir it up, and he's doing more of the same here and doing it all night. Concern on the Calgary bench for Tony Amonte.
Now Thorsen's stick came up, ooh, and smoked him right in the face. And Amonte is now up and seems to be okay, which is the good news for the Calgary Flames. And it'll be a 4-minute penalty to Thorsen, and there is the high stick again, and Amonte again was in pretty good pain. He was cut wide open.
He took it in the mouth. So Thorsen off for high sticking at 18:45 with 1:15 to go in the third period. The Flames 0-for-6 on the power play tonight.
Now there's a bit of blood on the ice here, and the reason there's a bit of a hold up is Jim Playfair asked to make sure they scrape the blood off the ice, which they should do, and now they're going to do that.
So there's a puddle.
Yeah, as Amonte took one right in the chops.
Big night for Tony Amonte. He had gone 20 games without a goal. And he snapped that drought with his 10th of the season in the second period.
Ginla mapping out a play on the power play. And the Flames with 4 minutes on the power play of 1:15 here to get a goal or two.
Flames facing their third consecutive loss. But again, the playoff picture has been decided with the defeat by Nashville of Colorado 4-2 tonight in Denver.
Can you imagine the urgency if that wasn't the case at the moment? With the Oilers up 3-2 and the Flames on the power play.
Face off outside the Calgary line. Flames on the power play. Reisner wins the draw back to Jason Smith. Smith will send it right down the ice inside the Calgary zone. Alex Tanguay to lead the rush for the Flames. Up the left wing side, Lanko ahead to Huselius. Huselius plays it in behind the goal to Lanko. Last minute of play, and the net is empty at the Calgary end. Giordano gloves it, comes in deep. His shot is blocked off the stick of Jason Smith. Giordano, D to D. Tange on the point with him. Giordano into the corner now. Roussalius back to the point. Tange, wrist shot through traffic, wide of the goal. Jerome Iginla plays it back to the point. Giordano looking for a seam. Tange down low again. Roussalius back to the point. Tange, Roussalius steps into the high slot and a one-timer fanned by Iginla. Giordano loses control of the puck and Reisner plays it down the ice. 15 seconds. Flames with a 6-on-4 situation. Jason Smith, Pyle drives it down the ice. And that will do it as the final seconds tick off the clock. You can hear some boos here in Calgary as the Edmonton Oilers wind up the season with a 3-2 victory over the Calgary Flames. Calgary outshooting Edmonton 30-28.
Well, it's been a long season for the Edmonton Oilers. At least they can finish it with a win. Meanwhile, the Calgary Flames getting ready to take on the Detroit Red Wings.
If you're over 50 with a good driving record, you could save up to $400 per year on your car insurance through Grey Power. Because at Grey Power, we believe that if you're over 50 and have a good driving record, you've earned the right to save. So call or visit us online right now for a free, no-obligation quote. Call now and get the power of 50+.
Call 1-866-494-5013 or go to graypower.com.
If you think a luxury sedan can't quicken your pulse, if you think luxury has to be complicated,
think we'll make it?
If you think safety is only about surviving accidents, think again.
The one you love doesn't know he could be carrying many viruses. Fact, viruses can live on surfaces for days. Lysol disinfectant spray with the power you trust helps stop the spread of viruses. Use it on common household surfaces to kill dangerous viruses like the flu. Lysol is the number one brand recommended by pediatricians. Lysol, disinfect to protect. Also get trusted Lysol protection with Lysol wipes.
With the innovative Rona by Design concept, it's almost that simple. Choose from among the latest in home facade styles to suit your tastes. Then bring your dream to life with our Rona experts. Rona by Design, from the Canadian How-To People.
Kingbird, and if that mockingbird don't sing, Daddy's gonna buy you a diamond ring. Shh.
You're good.
Why do WestJetters care so much? Because we're also WestJet owners.
Hey, Dwayne. Come around, Dwayne. Dwayne Rolson just stepping into the studio to join us now, but an Oilers win over the Flames with so much on the line for Calgary seemed ever so unlikely, but Edmonton finds a way. MasterCard 3 stars, Dwayne Rolson, Stefan Yell, and Elish Hemsky, 30-28, the shots tonight. And Dwayne Rolison, a deserving first star in a tough situation.
Sorry.
You kind of,
having trouble here. Having trouble here.
Having half your stuff off. Yeah. You came into tonight, Dwayne, with one win in 19 games. How did you manage to find a way against a team that had a lot to play for, at least for the first two periods?
Well, we just tried to play a smart game. You know, we sort of pinpointed this game on the calendar. Hopefully it meant something for us and them, so we can go out and play hard. And tonight we did. We played an unbelievable game for our team. With all the tough times we've had lately, we played great.
Were you coveting the opportunity perhaps to spoil the party for the Flames, or at least put them into a winner-take-all position in Colorado tomorrow?
Oh, we're just focusing on playing a good game. If we end up winning, that was great. We weren't, you know, trying to wreck their chances, that's for sure. We're just wanting to go play a smart, enthusiastic game and have some fun.
Were you watching the scoreboard to see how Colorado fared against Nashville?
I wasn't watching, but I heard it in the second period there that Nashville won.
You took note of it.
Yeah. And I don't usually listen to the speaker, but I heard Denver, so I just sort of listened in.
Did you expect the Calgary Flames, as a few other people around here tonight did, to come out with a bit more urgency in the first period?
Yeah. I thought we played well. You know, and that's why they didn't really, you know, generate as much as what a lot of people thought they were going to come out with. We just played really smart and try to eliminate their quality chances. They get a fluky one on the first one, and then, you know, Tony makes a great shot on the second one there. So, but as a team, we played great defensively and smart, and we capitalized on some chances that we were able to take. You know, we took advantage of the chances that we had.
Such a tough stretch for you since the trade deadline. How many times since the middle of February have you said to yourself, where did it all go wrong?
Well, yeah, we just try to forget about it. Losing Ethan Morrow in game five really hurt us. He was a great leader in our locker room, and, you know, he's not afraid to step up and answer the bell, whether, you know, it's a fight or a block shot, and sort of leads by example. But he's also, you know, if he has to be vocal, he's vocal. So, we really miss him. Then Stevie Stales got hurt, Danny Tarnquist got hurt, you know. So, you know, we had some key injuries, and it's unfortunate. And, you know, but the unfortunate thing, we're close enough to for next year. You know, we get a couple free agents, and you know, we're back at it.
Final question. You played your last game last season, I think it was on June the 19th. You had about 2 months off, and the knock was that a lot of players came back still ailing from injuries that they had suffered the previous season. It's not going to be a problem this year because you got 5 months off. What are your plans?
Well, first things first, I got to go to the World Championships at the end of the month here, and you know, go over there and play. And then after that, probably spend some time with my boys. We've had two 14, 15-day road trips here within the last month, so a month and a half. So it's, I haven't seen them much lately, so it's spend some time with them and spend some quality family time.
I forgot you were going to the World Championships.
Yeah, it should be fun.
Congratulations on that.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right, Dwayne Rollison, first star of tonight's game. Thanks a lot, Dwayne.
Thank you.
We're heading towards After Hours, live from Event Level at the Saddle Dome tonight. Eric Dehatchik, Greg Millen, Raj Binder of This Hour is 22 Minutes. We'll join Kelly and I as we preview the Stanley Cup playoffs. I got a feeling Raj will steal the show. 3-2, the final in Calgary in favor of the Oilers. More to come on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
I think you'll find this particularly fascinating. As you can see, gray represents new home sales, charcoal represents existing home sales, slate represents condominium sales, and graphite is commercial sales. Any questions?
Step up your presentations with color copies at Staples, now only 39 cents each. Staples Business Depot, that was easy.
Expedia.ca presents Lesson 1, Conversing in Italy.
Ciao! Perché sei così bella? Cosa ti ha portato a Roma? Il vento? Le stelle?
The stars? No. The Great European Vacation Sale? Yeah. Right now, your perfect European vacation is on sale. Just choose your flight and the hotel of your dreams, and presto, we'll get you there.
Aspetta! Vengo con te!
Expedia.ca. Your trip, your way.
Looking for the right mortgage? Come to TD Canada Trust, where we'll help you find a mortgage that has everything you're looking for, which could make all the difference.
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
Get the mortgage that's right for you. TD Canada Trust. Banking can be this comfortable.
A remarkable reenactment, seeing the Great War through the eyes of their ancestors, reliving the drama and the glory. A spellbinding two-part documentary by Brian McKenna. The Great War. Sunday night at 8. All part of the live return to Vimy Weekend on CBC Television.
Spring is here. And the Home Depot can help you make the most of it. From inspiration to installation. Build a new deck, get a new barbecue, or create a whole backyard paradise.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Edmonton Oilers came into the final game of the season with one win in 19, so it wasn't hard to bet against them tonight, but the bets lost in a 3-2 win over the Flames. Although, Kelly, you had a feeling this might happen after the first period.
Well, they didn't come out, I didn't think, with the urgency. This isn't an embarrassing loss. Let's make that straight. Although it's a really disappointing loss, and Flames players, I'm sure, will be disappointed for about half an hour. The ultimate goal is to make the playoffs, and they did that. And so now they have to move forward, erase these memories from the last three games, and get ready for the playoffs.
Yeah, the heat is off the Flames despite tonight's loss, because they're not going to Colorado in a winner-take-all or must-win position, given that Nashville finished off the Avalanche's playoff hopes tonight with this 4-2 win. J.P. Dumont led the way with a pair.
You know, Nashville have a really young defense, but an outstanding defense, so I think that they're going to be a real tough opponent for San Jose first round.
And say it again, the Avalanche went 14-2-2 since the trade deadline and still did not make the playoffs. Canucks go to OT in San Jose with a 4-3 win to clinch the Northwest. Jonathan Chichu scored with 33 seconds to go in regulation to tie it, but Matthias Olin won it in extra time. Roberto Luongo strong once again for the Canucks, and after the game, Elliot Friedman spoke to Luongo.
Really one of the best hockey games seen all year, Vancouver, San Jose, 4-3 Canucks in overtime. And Roberto, you know, you came here this year, there were so many expectations, and you know, this team is celebrating a division championship right now, a prediction that very few people would have made at the beginning of the year. What does it mean to you that you were such a big part of this team's surprising success?
Well, I think there's a lot of parts. I mean, not only myself, but a few other key players and obviously a new coach. So I brought in a good system, and guys have been working hard all year to, you know, do their job and play within the system. And, you know, we are rewarded today, finally.
You know, it's funny because you're there crediting the team and the system, and you ask all those guys, and they'll say, it's you.
Yeah, well, like I said, there's 20 guys on the team. I mean, last year in Florida, I couldn't do it by myself, so there's had to be something that went on here that's pretty good.
Well, there are about 18,000 fans who stood up here today about to celebrate a goal by Ryan Clough and couldn't believe it. There's the monitor down there. What are you thinking of as you lose your stick?
Well, I was trying to pick it up, and then I noticed he was going to go for a shot, and it hit our defenseman, so I just, it was kind of a desperation move, and last second I was able to get a piece of it, luckily, and keep it out there.
Well, this is what you have waited for your whole career, a chance at the Stanley Cup playoffs. First of all, going to play against Phoenix?
No, I'm not. I'm going to take the day off tomorrow.
Okay, so are you nervous at all? Like, how do you feel as you finally prepare for something you've waited for your whole career?
Well, I'm really excited right now. I can't wait to get it started, and I'm sure there's going to be a few nerves in there when the series starts, but I think the general feeling is just excitement, and I can't wait to just enjoy my first moments in the playoffs.
All right, one last thing we wanted to show you. This was the penalty you got in the second period, the delay of the game, and I just wonder, going into the playoffs, are you concerned about what you can do with the puck after this?
Well, I didn't try to freeze it right away. I tried to play it, and then when it came back to me, I mean, there was a bunch of guys around me, so I didn't really know what to do with it, and I froze it, so I don't know if that's a penalty or not. We're gonna have to go over it, but obviously it's gonna be important to know that once it starts.
All right, one final one quick. Martin Brodeur said he'd pick Crosby for MVP. Crosby said he'd pick either you or him. Who would you pick?
Well, I think I'd go with Crosby. I mean, he's top scorer in the league, and he took a team that you know, was very low in the standings to you know, one of the top seeds in the East. So you know, he did a remarkable job there in Pittsburgh this year.
Well, you're going to get a lot of votes anyway, despite not giving yourself one.
Oh,
congratulations,
you,
Roberto, and enjoy the playoffs.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
And so the Canucks are ready for a first-round matchup with the Dallas Stars as a result of this win this afternoon. The Leafs blew a 3-1 lead and somehow came back to beat Montreal 6-5 in a game that mystified but keeps the Leafs alive. They'll be in if New Jersey beats the Islanders tomorrow, Kelly.
I gave them no chance when it was 5-3 Montreal. It looked as though the Canadians had all the momentum and they were playing great. Ryder was unbelievable. They just didn't get anything in the end from their big guns like Kovalev.
Islanders in Jersey at 3:30 tomorrow afternoon, 3:30 Eastern on TSN. Ottawa 6-3 over Boston, so the Sens secure home ice to start the playoffs against Pittsburgh.
I don't know if starting at home ice is great for Ottawa. They have to learn how to deal with that pressure, and that's going to be a difficult task for them.
By the way, Heatley's goal was number 50. Islanders stayed alive in the East with that 4-2 win over Philadelphia. They jumped into a 3-0 lead, then held the Flyers off. How about Wade Dubowitz in the Islander goal?
He's played really well. Surprising. I know that they really miss DiPietro, but Dubowitz has been really steady.
Buffalo 2-0 over Washington to wrap up the President's Trophy with 53 wins on the season. Ryan Miller had the shutout, but surprisingly just his second of the season.
That is shocking. They score a lot of goals, though, so there's where all the wins come from. He's a great goalie, though, don't get me wrong.
Samuelson 2 goals, 5 points in Detroit's 7-2 win over Chicago. Detroit going to the playoffs for the 16th consecutive season. Andre Kopitar scored his 20th. That was the winner as LA beat Phoenix 3-2.
And Guerin getting the start there and the win.
Carolina beats Florida 5-4 in OT. Rod Brind'Amour the winner, and the Hurricanes had a record 53 shots, a team record 53 shots in that game. Atlanta beats Tampa 3-2. John Sim had the winner.
And Atlanta, they're a little weak on defense, so I don't know how deep they're going to go into the playoffs.
Should say that was a shootout winner for Sim. Yeah. Anaheim 4-3 over Columbus. Timo Solani with a pair to finish the season with 48.
Anaheim, boy, they're a favorite.
Pittsburgh beats the Rangers 2-1, but Ottawa's win over Boston keeps the Penguins in the number 5.
Two excellent teams. They could go really deep in the playoffs. I like both those teams.
And the old guys, Roberts and Recchi, yeah, with the goals for Pittsburgh. Minnesota 5-1 over St. Louis in a game that didn't mean anything for the Wild because Vancouver clinched the Northwest earlier in the day. And here in Calgary, Edmonton upsets the Flames 3-2, but the Heat's off the Flames because they get into the playoffs as a result of Nashville defeating Colorado. So the playoff matchups in the West, Calgary has a date with Detroit. We're told that might start as late as Friday. Dallas at Vancouver on Wednesday night. We'll have that game for you. Nashville meets San Jose, Anaheim, Minnesota. In the East, Buffalo will meet either the Leafs or Islanders. That's the only matchup left to be decided. Jersey and Tampa confirmed, Atlanta and the Rangers, and Ottawa, Pittsburgh to start in Ottawa. So we'll continue to head to After Hours here at the Pengrove Saddledome on the heels of a 3-2 Edmonton win.
Overpriced beer? Well, now's the time to switch to Lakeport Pilsner, Lakeport Light, or Lakeport Honey Lager. We're still 2-4 for 2-4. Lakeport. Great beer, fair prices. You ask for cans, and Lakeport delivers. Lakeport Pilsner, Lakeport Light, and Lakeport Honey Lager, now in cans for the lowest legal price. That's $10 less a 2-4 than regular beer. Lakeport. Great beer, fair prices.
Is it Mickey Viagra?
Viagra, Flabberjumper, Viagra, Basil Knocker, Flangerati.
Flangerati? Nick Bibley, Tom Tufty.
Looking for the right mortgage? Come to TD Canada Trust, where we'll help you find a mortgage that has everything you're looking for, which could make all the difference.
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
Get the mortgage that's right for you. TD Canada Trust. Banking can be this comfortable.
It's a dinky chickly. Viagra, Tufty Doodle.
Wollstone?
Viagra Nanny Wobblechuck? Viagra Womble Minky.
Knuckle Step?
Oilers somehow close out one of their toughest seasons in memory with a 3-2 win over the Flames. As upsets go, this would be one, but the Flames avoid disaster because of Nashville's win over Colorado. Want to remind you to take part in our playoff pool. There's lots of cash and merchandise on the line here. First prize, $20,000. Prizes awarded after each round, and go online to enter. So, Kelly, should the Calgary Flames be concerned that they're heading to Colorado for the final game tomorrow on a three-game losing streak at a bad time of the year?
Actually, I don't think so. I still think they're an excellent team. In fact, now that they're playing the number one seed, Detroit, they may enter that series feeling a lot less pressure and not thinking that that all the pressure's on them, and because they didn't handle it well in the last week. So I actually kind of think that they're going to play this underdog role in take it in good terms, and they're okay with it.
Regular season wraps up tomorrow. We're in the process of finalizing our broadcast schedule, but somebody is 16 wins away from the Stanley Cup, the toughest route to any pro sports championship, and we'll preview it next on After Hours.
Now that you can tow whatever you need, haul whatever you want. The only acceptable use of the word but is right after the word kick. The all-new 2008 Ford Super Duty. Built Ford Tough.
I can't read this. Can you read this?